I need to speak to the man in charge, fellas. Don't point that gun at him. He's an unpaid intern. Vikram, what kind of coverage you get?
I just kept it rolling until I put this hood over my head.
Bill speaks their language. What are they saying, Billy?
Hold on.
Sasalita ng Pilipino to.
Alam ko.
Kidnapin natin siya.
Ako? Ano naman kayo pwede kong magawa? How ako ang shake? Okay, apparently they're taking a hostage. Obviously, they've chosen Ned.
Alit sila.
Opo. Hoy! Ibalik ang bata!
Now that they've found out that I speak Filipino, they seem to be changing their
mind. Kanin ba ito?
Kahadiyero. Nasaan ang kahadiyero?
Kahadiyero? Walang ditang kahadiyero. Do you have a vault? They want to know if there's a vault.
There's no vault. Our vault contains at least 10 different currencies from all over the world at any given moment, and we are prepared for every kind of financial necessity. There goes Ned's inheritance. Tell them if they don't get off my boat right now, there's going to be a major shitstorm.
Makinig kayo. Kung ayaw ninyong magalit ang mangga marino, la luna ang kapitan na nakakaramdan, makinig bagyo ng tide na pipo.
Neno, can you hear me?
We'll get you back, Billy.
Is everybody else safe? Anne-Marie, you okay, honey?
No, I'm not. I told you these were unprotected waters.
What a fucking nightmare. Be cool on this shit, okay, Cubby? I mean, at least try to show both sides.
I need to find a baby for this father.
Yeah, I think I know what you mean.
Hello, everybody. This is Nick the Rat coming to you live from the SS Sewer Sub. Submarine? Submariner? SS Sewer Sub. It's a SSSS. It's a S to the fourth power. Coming to you live. This is episode 233. 233, everybody. So we're going to rock this stuff off with the banquet beer Coors. We like the tall boy Coors. $1.50. Not bad. Tonight we are we are coming to you from the SS Sewer Sub. We're not in the sewers of Brooklyn, New York right now. South Brooklyn, where it's at. Whoop. Currently the moon phase is waxing gibbous, and the illumination's at 93%, everybody. So that's the good sign that shit's gonna get weird tonight. Yes, Ned, you could send on beer on over. Red Rover, send beer on over. But that's not the interesting thing tonight. You might be like, Nick the Rat, why are you in a submarine made by the brilliant dark sewer scientist in, you know, the sewer, and not in the sewers of Brooklyn, New York tonight? Well, everybody, the scientist sent me an email. Yes, it's been months. It's been like 3 months since I've even seen or smelled or sniffed or stolen popcorn crumbs from a scientist in a long time. One came by. I jumped on his shoulder and he threw me at a wall, so I don't know what's going on out there. They said, Nick the Rat, get the fuck out of the sewers tonight. They are douching the sewer systems of New York. They didn't tell me when or why or how. So I was like, I gotta get the fuck out of here. And then, all of a sudden, it was great. It was incredible. The man, the myth, the legend, Zindu, everybody. Zindu from Oaktar actually called me. He was like, Nick, I can't tell you everything because I'm under an NDA. But the dark sewer scientist gave him the ability to captain this submarine. So he's actually up in the captain's booth. I'm in the passenger's cabina. Doing the show from the submarine. And I was like, you know, we gotta go out there. We gotta do this. But then I was like, well, what are we gonna do for the show? I just can't just do it underwater. We need to make a show out of this. And he told me he bought a map to a monster's lair in Lake Champlain. So tonight, everybody, we are actually currently in Lake Champlain. I think we're still near the southern part of it right now. If I'm looking at the map on the back of the seat in front of me, I'm the only one here. There's like room for like 12 people here in this submarine, but it's just me. And I think Zindu's at the front. I haven't seen him yet, but he'll probably be coming out. Yeah. Yes, Lavish, under the sea, beer can. Don't swim in the water. Dude named Ben. Bem? Oh, is that Sir Bemrose? I did hear that the water here can get a lot of blue-green algae, which a lot of hipsters like to drink, but I hear it eats holes in your brain. So you might want to not do that. You might not want to get that blue-green algae in you. I know it might be good for you. It might also be bad. That's my problem with the health Mike, of...
Alpha, November, Oscar, X-ray.
That was Bill from accounting.
Sierra, Uniform, Bravo, Alpha, Lima. And just stand by one.
They're having slight conversations about it. Yeah, but blue-green algae might eat holes in your brain. I don't know. That might help you in the long run in the world that we're in today. Who? Am I picking up radio chatter here? Okay, I think they're actually giving us the right to go deeper into the lake over here. Okay, so either way, I remember that was I think that was from the dude from accounting. So tonight we are going to have a show from Lake Champlain. We're going to be hunting down some lake monsters. This is one of this is a huge lake. Let me tell you. Zindu is telling me all these facts. I don't even know how he knows all this shit, actually. But maybe we'll hear from him a little bit later. We will have music tonight. We always have some of the newest, freest music that I could find out there. I'm DJing it up for you guys. You know, it's going to be a good time there. We're going to have open lines. We're live right now. You could call and leave a voicemail at 917-719-5923. Leave a voicemail there. I'll play it soon. In about 30 minutes or so, maybe after we get a little bit a little further north, maybe like 30 degrees further, more like 5 degrees further, maybe even less than that, like 1 degree further up north, be opening up the phone lines. We could talk about anything. We don't have to talk about lake monsters. If you would like to call me and talk about your underwear, I'm down to talk about your underwear. I like how many knots? I got one in my robe right now. I got one knot going. Wait, Fletcher's in here too? Is Fletcher up in the chat room? I want to say, before we also start, happy birthday to Carblanes, Carol Blaney from Hog Story. Bam. It's her birthday recently. That's awesome. I don't see Fletcher up in here. Either way, that's about all for right now. I think that's... Oh, Fletcher is up in here. Look at that. Okay, cool. Oh, my chat screens are working. I'm just happy that everything is working down this far underwater right now. Whew. Okay. Okay, so music. Zindu's going to be probably teaching us some stuff. He said he'll chime in during the show a couple times. We'll have a gas blast, too. You could email nick@nicktherat.com and send an email in. If you put gas blast in the title, I'll read it on the air if it's not fucking horrible. If I get to, if you write me something horrible, I've gotten about, like, because also last week I did a whole show on relaxation and meditation, and to do that, I had to do it a little semi not live. So there was no phone calls last week. So also I didn't talk about the donation segment last week either. So this might be a long show, might be a little bit longer, but we're all, everybody over here is used to long. That's what I heard. So we're going to be fine. We're going to be fine. I'm fine. You're fine. And in times like these, we need to be fine together. Together, people. Fine. I think there's a... I think there's some more beer that I have to drink right here. Okay, you know what? We're going to listen to the first song of the evening. And then we're going to get into it. We're going to get deep in this lake. I hope Champlain is a... Well, I hope it's a lady lake. You know, there's like the lake of the lady. Okay, whatever. Fucking, let's just start it. Let's start doing this. The song number one is from Electric Senses. And I actually just found out because most of the time on these, on SoundCloud, I will post my comments on the creator's music and be like, hey man, you're fucking awesome. Like, because there's a lot of garbage out there. Tons of garbage. You don't know how much music I have to listen to get the 9 or 10 songs that I play every night. Or Wednesday night. Not every night. Do it every Wednesday. But to find that, the magical moments of music, I have to mow majestically through malarkey. Oh shit, it's Melodious Owl. He just joined up too. How you doing, brother? Stay safe in Brooklyn. Hold it down for me. Hold it down. Sturgeon Law, 99% of everything is horseshit. This is very true. I didn't... Who's the sturgeon? And if I'm getting sturgery, I hope he's not the one giving it to me. Okay. Woo. Here we go. Here we go. Number one is by Electronic Senses. I messaged this person on SoundCloud. I said, your music is you're killing it. You're doing awesome. You're amazing. I probably threw in some slang like you're killing it or it's fire. You're doing great. And then they sent a message back saying, I don't speak English. I use a translator. Don't know what you're saying. So I was looking through the rest of the comments and it looks like he speaks Spanish. So I said, muy bueno. I think that means I like pasta in Italian. So the first song we have is from Electronic Senses. And it's all English though. I don't know why they don't just do it in Spanish. It's fine. I'll find music in any language here. I Wanna Know is the song. And it's Mucho Fuego. I should have wrote that. That's true, Lavish. Thank you very much. Here we go with Electronic Senses. I Wanna Know. We'll be right back.
hot steam directly in my skull cave. Skull cave.
Well, welcome back to Nick the Rat. This is, we're doing it live from a submarine, everybody. Submarine Nick the Rat. This is craziness. Okay, I'm just gonna break down how it's gonna go for a little bit, because some people like to just know what's coming up. Some people don't like to know that. Some people like to be surprised. But some people like to just know how it works. And if you're one of those people that like to know how it works, here's how it is going to work. It's going to start off with me going through a gas blast. Maybe I'm going to play a voicemail. Maybe I'll talk about how I feel being underwater right now, because I'm kind of freaking out a little bit. I'm not a big fan of being under here. It's tight quarters. There's a lot of pressure. I hope I hear from fucking Zindu soon. But let's see if we have any gas blast over here, because we have a lot to go through. And then, segment two. I mean, after the B block. What is that? What do they call that? It's just talking to myself over here. There's nobody over there. Nobody over there either. Okay, we're after we go through, after we play the next song, we're going to thank people. And then after the song, after that, we're going to open up the phone line. So if you want to call in, if you want to talk to me live, in front of all these sewer chatters over here, all of them, like blah 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 blah, blah. All of them. We could do that. But you're gonna have to wait a little bit. Calm down. Put your phone down, or pick it up and call me and leave a voicemail. Do I see the champ, Nick the Rat? I don't know what you're talking about. Net. Shh. Let's look at the sewer chat. I mean, gas blast. Fuck, and I have to open up the gas blast letters. 1 second here. Let's. Oh, we don't have too many gas blasts. Actually, we might have. I don't know. Let's just go back to over here. First gas. Oh, motherfuckers. Okay, look here. I'll read it. It's not so bad. It's about May. And I could handle what you're dishing. Throw it on me. Yeah, people were dumping on me. People were dumping on Nick the Rat. Before I read this gas blast, people were dumping on me on Twitter, and even on No Agenda Social. They were dumping on me. You know what I did? I didn't give a fuck. I just didn't give. There's a lot of people that can't handle pressure, especially from internet pressure. And there's only one point when when internet pressure becomes a little bit too much. When they kind of bleed it over into the real world. When if they were to dox you or find your home address or call, fucking. Once the internet bleeds into reality, that's too far. But everything before that is open for debate, for discussion, for anything. These assholes, though, on Twitter, let's talk, and on The guy, actually, you know, he was an asshole too. He was the No Agenda Social guy. If you're listening, which you're probably not, because you don't like me. You think that I'm like a favorite of the No Agenda show. You think that, like, oh, they just chose Nick stuff because he's a, no, they didn't choose me because I'm like a fucking favorite, and they don't air my podcast because I'm a favorite either. No, they do it because it's called open source, you asshole. If you put out a product and you give it for free, this show is free. You could take this and resell it. If you resold this product, I wouldn't even give a fuck. You can't spell art without rat. Lavish is on fire tonight. with the comments. But look, they don't play favoritism with me. I've actually submitted artwork for the past 10 years. God damn it. I donated, you know what's funny? I only donated once to Nick the Rat, okay? I donated once to get the challenge coin. I gave them like $50, but I've given them so much of my time that I deserve a night ring, Adam Curry. No, okay. Where am I going with this? Okay, where am I going with this? Adam actually stuck up for me, and he shut those two haters down. Thank you, Adam. I just want to say thank you to Adam Curry. I want to open the show by just thanking Adam Curry for shutting those haters down. Bad haters. But if you want to hate on me, go for it. So the whole point of this is hate on me, but don't let it bleed over. Yeah, haters are going to hate. Don't let it bleed over to the real world. Like, if you're going to put words into me, sure, that's fine. But don't talk to my mother. Okay? Don't you dare call my mother ever again and tell her that she looks good in her nightgown, you piece of shit. I don't know how you have her webcam feed or how you know that she's my mother, but if you do that again, I'm going to... But sure, diss my art. Tell Adam and John that they're playing favoritism with me and they should choose your fucking Pink Floyd album cover, but instead of colors of the rainbow, you used brown as the thing because you thought it was clever. And you brought up your hate and your madness and you're a meanie. But it's fine. I actually enjoyed it. I enjoyed it. Adam yelled at you, so that's fine. Okay, let's read this gas blast here. I'm way off on tangent now. Sultan of Soy. Are you pro-scrub or anti-scrub? Okay. See, this motherfucker calls me the Sultan of Soy, but that's fine. Because he at least put Sultan in there. If he called me like a soy shithead or a... something that's bad with S. Soy Sith? Ugh. If he called me a soy Sith, I wouldn't read his thing. I would... or soy stormtrooper. Soy PN. Okay. But am I pro scrub or anti scrub? Let's see. I would have to say pro. I am pro scrub. In almost all senses of the word. Almost all of them. Because you need... Okay, well, let's look at it. Let's go through this. We have to go through... Because I have no idea what this motherfucker that called me the Sultan of Soy is talking about. Because... Why should I know what this asshole was talking about? You're not an asshole. It's fine. I'm just venting. I'm venting. I think there's... I had to take some drops before I got into the submarine because I'm... bad with the pressure. I'm bad with pressure. So I took a couple of drops of something. The scientist said it would calm me down, but I think it's just freaking me out. Okay, so scrubbing. In the sense of the rub down, as in cleaning, welcome to the chat, Scandy. I would say scrubbing is good because it cleans. It cleans. It's, you need to scrub. If you get poison ivy on your body, you need to scrub with like dishwashing soap. It's like grease. It gets all in there. If it gets all in there, you need to scrub. You need to scrub. You need to scrub your dishes. You can't just wet your dishes. Need to scrub. Okay, so that's the first sense of it. As in to clean, I would say scrub is pro scrub. Now, what are the other... What are the other ways? What are the other things about scrubs? Scrub your balls, indeed. You gotta scrub them down. You can't just not scrub your balls down. Otherwise, there's gonna be a weird stink down there. Which is only enticing to yourself. But please, scrub your balls. Now, a scrub as in a human or a person or a personality. It depends. It depends on if I'm pro that. Truthfully, I would have to say that I am pro scrub. I do like failures because a scrub is a failure, right? Like, it's like, oh, that person tried to do something, but they a scrub. They couldn't complete the task. I guess I would be pro losers because that lets me be a winner. You can't be in the pyramid. Say there's a pyramid. If there's no scrubs, if there's nothing at the bottom, you can't build a house without a foundation. Scrubs are the foundation. When you see the scrub, you know what to not do. It's also good to recognize the scrub so you could avoid the scrub. You need to get away. You need to sometimes distance you and the scrub. But it's good to recognize the scrub. And the scrub elevates us all. The scrub elevates the non-scrub-er. Now there's the weird question. Because... in a lot of people's eyes, I am the scrub. I am the scrub, and I understand that. They don't like how I talk. They don't like my artwork. They don't like my affiliations. They don't like my thoughts or my ideas. And is that okay? Well, yeah, because my shit is your foundation to be who you are. Just try to be a good person. Try to level... Now, If you're out there and you're shitting on people, sometimes I guess you gotta shit on people sometimes. That's why it's fine to do that. Just don't call my mother ever again. Okay. Wait. It looks like Zindu might be trying to call. I'm seeing a red light over here. Is that the Zindu?
Bestie 1212 123. Yes, everybody. Welcome to the SS Sewer Sub. This is your captain speaking.
Oh, good.
You can call me Master Zindu.
Master? No.
I own your ass now. Welcome to the ride, baby. Okay. So I'm going to take this nice and easy for all of you because you're probably all virgins to you know, being in a submarine underwater. And I want to get you guys all wet, nice and slow. I don't like to force people to get wet. So let's get your little water slippies on or whatever the fuck you're going to wear, your little tighty tight whiteies or whatever you're going to put on, and let's get ready for an adventure. Because tonight, we're hunting for a great lake monster. Now, as you can see, we're already pretty deep down in the Lake Champlain area. If you look out the left window, you'll notice it's blacked out. And if you look out your right window, you'll notice it is also blacked out. Right now we are protecting the security of the invasive species of the area, such as the zebra mussels, the alewives, the fishhook water fleas, the spiny water wear fleas, the Eurasian water milfoils, the sea lampreys, and all those other things out there. You know, just the invasive species. We're trying to protect them by, you know, not letting you see them. You know, because as they're destroying the beautiful environment of this lake. We figured that blacking out the windows and not showing you the horrors that might be around you right now, it'll give you an awareness of what you're not seeing, okay? So we figured that, you know, just blacking it all out, you can't see anything, then that might be the best course of action. But don't worry, because we have the sensors on and the radars turned on, and I've got total control of those. I'm seeing them. But you're not seeing them. So let's make sure we keep that up. Because, you know, don't worry. Because, you gotta trust the system. The system is here for you, and I am the system. I am Master Sindhu. I mean, Captain of the SS Sewer Sub. If you didn't know, Lake Champlain was named after Samuel de Champlain. He was a French explorer in 1609. So we're gonna be going around these waters here that he went around a long time ago in 1609. And he discovered this water, yeah, for sure, yeah, sure. Just like Columbus discovered America and Zindu discovered Earth. Well, I did discover Earth. He got my name on a plaque up on Oak Tar. But anyway, alright, we're gonna be taking a little intermission. We'll be back. I'll be back when we got more updates coming to you from the cabin of the SS Sewer Sub. Keep your arms and legs inside, otherwise you're gonna get sucked out and probably eaten by something. So we didn't sign any waivers. Enjoy. We'll be right in a little bit. Okay. Captain out.
Trust the system. Trust the man. Trust yourself. You can't really trust you are the system. And you know, it's weird. There was a lot of sayings that happened a long time ago that I think still stand very true. A couple of the sayings are, beer is awesome. Duh. Put on your shoes on your hands. Is that what it is? Put yourself in other people's shoes. That's the other one. The problem with we getting close to a wall or something. The problem with putting on other people's shoes is sometimes they might not want to hear your opinion. Like if you don't like Nick the Rat Radio, you just turn me off. You just take the dial and go, and you could, you know, whatever you want to put on, it's fine. But you never know when you should say something. I guess there should be like a, before you say anything to anybody, there should be a disclaimer. That's how we could fix everything. Disclaimer. Well, it's only for social issues between similar people in a level area. If it's like your boss, if your boss or somebody that has a gun to your head is talking to you, you can't say what I'm about to tell you to do. But if the person doesn't pay your paycheck or doesn't have a gun, you could try to say, can I speak openly? Are you easily offended if I said something that you might not like? Would you talk about my mother and her fucking nightgown? Okay, just try that. Put a disclaimer before you talk to somebody. Let's listen to Pold with underwater sounds.
Thank you.
I was pulled with underwater sounds. All this music could be found on SoundCloud/NickTheRat/likes. I mill SoundCloud for CC by 3.0 music. There are people out there putting music out for free. But sometimes these people that put their music out for free on SoundCloud does not play well with YouTube. YouTube will take those songs that those people put out for free on SoundCloud and tell me that somebody owns them. And if I ever make money off YouTube, which I'm making billions off of them. I'm making billions off of them still. That's why I don't care. I don't care because I'm getting billions of dollars from there. But YouTube will take those billions of dollars that I made and give it to the creator that claimed the 3 hours of show that I made. So that's why I do donations, because I'm not making money off of you. I mean, I'm making billions off YouTube, but that goes to like one or two people per episode. I think every episode that I put out so far has been claimed by YouTube. And my personal account was disabled years ago. That's when I knew that YouTube was garbage, was when I think my mom like uploaded a video of her in her lingerie, her nightgown, and what were in those drops? But YouTube is a great storage facility if you're doing, if you privatize. You could just make your YouTube page private. Upload gigabytes or terabytes of shit you just want to keep for yourself. And it might be safe. It might be safe. They still might cancel your account one day because they changed their layout and poof, you're gone. So it might be safe. But, you know, if you upload it to YouTube and you really want to save it, if it's like a really important thing, like the time you accidentally ran over a cow in your spaceship and you wanted to save that video, you might want to put it to YouTube and also save it locally. But what was the point here? The point here is that people still, they donate money to the show. And I guess you could tell by the amount of money that has been donated. I'm drinking Coors. I heard that it's good to complain. I would still do this either way. Maybe a good method is to completely play it off like you don't care. Maybe I'm still trying to find the good method. But either way, it's about finding good stuff. Actually, you know what? I'm looking at the milk drop, because if you're watching the video version of this, I use the milk drop visualizer in Winamp, 1999 tech year. And currently, I'm just going to flip back to it. I don't know if you're in the... I'm seeing a whole bunch of... shapes. I'll just say shapes. If you're looking at the if you're watching on twitch.tv or on YouTube and you're seeing the shapes, you might be understanding what I'm talking about. If you're listening to the podcast, because I do put this podcast out, there's an RSS feed. You could listen. The best part about podcast crop circles, they look like vaginas. If on the crop circles, cinnamon rolls. Sure, okay. I'm seeing 1, 2, 3, 4, at least 4 vaginas. Maybe five, six. Maybe six. There might be six of them there. Vagina cinnamon rolls. There we go. Okay. If you're, I love podcasts because when you're doing something banal, it's. People a long time ago they didn't even have Walkmans or Discmans or any of those things. And when they finally got them, it was amazing for them. But they had like 45 minutes of content per cassette, or it was like you have to spend money to get a thing that had about 30 minutes worth of fatality with a butt canal. You'd have to spend all this money on just like 40 minutes. People would re-listen and listen and listen and listen and listen again to the same content constantly. But now with podcasts, you got the RSS feed. It because there's a lot of like podcasts that have videos and all that. But then you need to use your eyes. Sometimes you just want your ears. Sometimes you don't want to use your eyes and you just want to use your ears. There's really no reason to watch a podcast. But there is a reason to watch it, because sometimes you want to see 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, like four cinnamon rolls on your screen. Oh, what's up, Tunnel Rat? How you doing? Welcome to the show. And if you like the vagina cinnamon rolls, you could donate at nicktherat.com/donate. I think that's it. Let's see who donated the past 2 weeks. I wasn't around last week. I don't read the name or the email address. I read the initials within the PayPal, usually, donation. All the time. I think it's all PayPal. I also have a P.O. box, which I'll tell you later, but sometimes I mess this up too, because sometimes PayPal just gets fucky with it. If you don't have a PayPal account, I think that's when it gets a little fucky. But let's go back for the past 2 weeks of PayPal donations. I will read initials, a note. If there's a note in the PayPal, I'll read that. If it's a subscription of $420 or other amount, I will say it's a subscription. I will say the amount that it is. And I will give the initials of the person or email or whatever they give. If you want that to change, if you want to be doxxed a little bit more, let me know. Some people are like, I want to be anonymous. So I'd rather just keep them anonymous. It's also open source. The more anon, the better. One guy, I think his name was George Shapiro. I think that was his name. I totally doxed him. I said his first name and his last name, and I also gave his address. It was like 3694 Longview Avenue, Santa Monica Boulevard. I did something like that, and he got really pissed off because people kept coming to his house and was like, why do you listen to Nick the Rat? He's a fucking soy boy piece of shit, and now I'm going to set your house on fire. So I tried not to read their entire name like I did with that. Aw, fuck. Okay, hi. Here we go. We're going to go on this road to donations now with just thanking people. You'll know who you are. If you donated, you'll know who you are. That's how I'd like to do it. I like to do it so you know I'm talking to you, but nobody else could find out who I'm talking to. That kind of makes my head hurt. Maybe I'm just making it all up. Might all be lies. There might be real people involved, or they might all be in my head. First donation from 2 weeks ago. I don't know. I'm just going to say all these donations might have been 2 weeks ago. This might have already been read. I don't know. But it's so generous. I will read it again. Okay. The note says that I could say their name. So I will. $100 billion. 100 billion dollars. No wonder I could do the show from a submarine. Comes from NetNed. See, now, like, if I told you somebody donated $100 billion, and then I was like, NetNed, and he lives in Ohio, Alaska, you'll go to his house and be like, I want some of that money. NetNed donation. Thanks for being a light to make the stupid state shut down a little bit more bearable. Fuck yeah. Thank you, NetNed. NetNed, thank you so much. If you're in the chat room, ask that guy to buy you a mansion. Wait, no, we have to read all the donations. I have to speed this up. I'm sorry. I like to stretch things out a little bit. Here we go. JF. That's a very hard one to figure out. Before I read this donation, I would just like to say, listen to Hog Story. Hog Story is a great story. With the $6 billion, 69 cents. That's a monthly donation, by the way. JF. with $6 billion and 69 cents. I don't know why you put the 69 cents on there after the $6 billion. I think that'll be fine, especially if it's monthly. The next one comes from... That's a receipt for the other one. There we go. See, sometimes PayPal gives you receipts. You think you get more donations than you actually do. Thank you, Melodious Owls. We have AE with a 420. 420 is a normal subscription. I think this show is worth a dollar a week. I put it out weekly for the past three years, and it's like 2 to 3 hours of music that I found that might be completely free or claimed on YouTube, and fun times. Wow, this is gonna be a long show. This is gonna be a long show. It's almost midnight in the sewer. I gotta speed this up. It's usually 11:30 by now. It's almost midnight. Thank you for that. The 420 donation a month for AE. We have, let's go a little bit quicker. We have DV with a 420. DV with a 420 monthly. Thank you very much. We have an MY. MY with a 420 monthly. Thank you. Thank you so much, MY. And holy shit. Holy shit. This is not monthly. This is a one-time shot. We have an OB. With a 3003. Numerology. 3003. That means I gotta turn the show off. All right. Good night, everybody. No, I'm joking. That's the receipt for that one. Thank you so much. There's a new tools for PayPal. That's cool. Thank you, PayPal. We have an AC with the one dizzy. Thank you, AC, for the one dizzy a month. I donate $1 to $2. I think it's $2 to $3 to a Star Trek podcast, the Penske File. If you like Star Trek, and these people share my opinion mainly on most stuff. I never really listened to their show. I was like, wow, their opinion of Star Trek sucked. The Penske File. I think it's a Seinfeld thing, but they've been doing the show forever. They're great. I think they went through everything so far. But AM, $1. Thank you so much. Then we have JP. JP with 42E. 420. Thank you very much, JE. We have CC with 333. CC with the 333 monthly. Thank you incredibly, incredibly much for that. It's a receipt for that one. All right, so I thought I was doing really good this week, but half of them are just receipts. We have PLLC with 1414. Numerology, 1414. I think that was the... Oh, man. If you have a... Well, it's good that I upload my videos in potato quality, because you could probably look at my glasses and see the magic happening. But you won't be able to read it. That's the receipt for that one. Thank you very much. 1414 for the LLC. We have A-N. A-N. With 420. Thank you, A-N. For the 420. This is the past 2 weeks of donations, by the way. Past 2 weeks. Holy, what the fuck? Oh, that's me sending out an invoice to somebody for a lot of money. Okay, so yeah, that was the donations. Thank you so much, everybody that has donated. If you want to donate to me, you could go to nicktherat.com or nicktheratradio.com. Thank you for the dancing creatures, Ducky. I see them over there. You can hit donate, and you could send a donation there. There's also a P.O. box. The P.O. box is working. Let me, I don't know it by heart. I gotta make a rhyme for it. So if you click on nicktherat.com and go to social, the bottom has a place you could send physical mail to. I've tried Nicholas the Rat, Nick the Rodent, most of the, just write Nick at P.O. box 90549. At Brooklyn, New York, 11209. I need to figure out a theme song for that. P.O. Box 90549, Brooklyn, New York, 11209. Oh, so far, the only mail I've gotten there was from me, and it worked, so that's good. Maybe I'll do a voicemail really quick. Let's listen to a voicemail. I'm going way too slow here. It is midnight in the sewer. It's midnight 02. We're Nick the Rat Radio, where you could call in and join the community. Become one with Nick the Rat and Sewer Chat.
Nick, there's a used Band-Aid eating contest tomorrow at 5 o'clock. It's what we've been training for all spring, man. I know that you've got this, dude, all right? No, good. You know, don't eat before, at least 2 hours before. Because they tend to expand, even if they're full of pus. Okay. We got this, man. I believe in you.
9549 9495951295209049 2. That's my social security number. Rob me now. Let's listen to another song, and then we're going to open up the phone lines. It's midnight in the sewer, everybody. Thank you for hanging out for the past hour. We're going to open it up to talk to other people. It's going to be a long episode. I don't know how this is going to... I'm scared. What were in those drops? We got Stereo Prism with Accelerating Universe. We'll be right back. That was Stereo Prism with Accelerating Universe. I was just accelerating through my tabs here. I gotta go back to the man there. Hello, everybody. Nick the Rat Radio. Let's just go on back to people hating, and groups. I like when groups are. I think there's a very good feeling or evolution of society when groups will kind of like connect. Like I was talking about the Penske podcast. They do Star Trek stuff, and. There's usually two hosts. There's a few people, but all the people that they have that do the show, it feels like I'm involved in it, and some things I might not agree with them, but it's good when you're the Penske file. It's good when you're connected to the community in some way, like to talk to the host or people that are listening, to know other listeners of the show. And that's the benefit of No Agenda as well. Like there's people that are giving you to that donate. No, there's a lot of people that donate there. There's a lot of people that give their time there. But when you add to when you become the crap at the bottom of that hill, and the hill gets bigger, it feels good. It feels good to be inside of the to know you are the scrub. I'm gonna open the phone line now. Wait, what is it? Wait, the light's blinking. We have to listen to Captain Zindu first, and then we will open up the phone lines.
This is your captain speaking. We had a lot of complaints from the Karens in the passenger cabin, but luckily there's only one passenger in the cabin today, Nick. So we've opened the curtains to check out the beautiful lake. We've ended blackout of the windows, so now you can actually see what's going on. As you can see, there's not too much of an invasive species here where we are currently, so, you know, you enjoy the sights, enjoy the beautiful lake that we're inside of right now. It's really, it is quite, me tell you a little bit. Let me tell you some stuff about it. It's 120 miles long of nice, fresh water loveliness filled with monsters. I'm sure if it's filled... We'll find something down here. Don't worry. This is not going to be a wild goose chase because there's no geese underwater. We're going to find a nice, good old monster for us, though. I'm telling you, I didn't take you guys out here for nothing, okay? At its thickest, it's 12 miles wide. Sort of like your captain's member, if you know what I'm trying to say. And at its deepest, it's about 420 feet. 420. Captain needs to get his pipe. Where's my pipe? We'll light up after. I don't think sailors are allowed to smoke weed while they can drink, though. Hold on a second. Yeah, that's tough. Okay. Alright. This pervert of a lake, it touches New York, Vermont, and Ontario. Fucking worldwide, baby. It's crazy. This thing is—it's all over the place. It's huge. I think it's one of the 8th biggest freshwater lakes on planet Earth. This place sucks. There's not much freshwater out there. Let's see. And today, we'll be looking for some underwater monsters. Will it be the creature from the Black Lagoon? A giant leech monster? Who knows? But I'm sure we'll find something. Something very soon. Something terrifying, huge. It's gotta be down here. I know it is. Somebody gave me a map. We're gonna be following this map. I think I can follow this. Anyway, we'll be back. We'll be back with more very soon. After I figure out how to read this map. Well, maybe if I drink some more. Okay, yeah. Cut the feed. We'll be back in a little bit.
Oh fuck! What is he? Sindhu's been drinking. That's not good. Okay, we're gonna put the phone lines now. The 917-719-5923. If you don't get in right away, it's might be a little busy. There might be a lot of busy phone lines going on. There's a lot of people calling in right now. There's a lot like this person is.
Hey, Nick. I was just calling to tell you your show fucking sucks. Actually, it's pretty good. Usually I only call you when you have the music that sucks playing, and I can call without missing content. But now you're talking. What is your stream? So I've probably downloaded that shit already. But I just wanted to tell you, I miss you. I wanted you to call me.
You want me to call you?
430-201-4841.
Okay, just stop. I have to edit that out. That might be a fake number. You know, Art Bell used to do this. Art Bell used to have a show. Used to have a lot. No, he used to have energy. And he used to take people's last names. People would call him and be like, oh, my name is Marianne Beth from, like, Atlanta or something. And then at one point, I think somebody called in and was talking about, because Art would push the limits of what you could say on public radio, like on actual things you could hear in your house on like an AM receiver. And somebody called in and was talking about how, like, the FBI was, something about, like, the FBI or killing the FBI. It was fucked up. It was, like, a fucked up thing, and he said it on the air, and he said his name, and then, like, the FBI came to Art Bell's studios. Apparently, the FBI was there several times. Now, the FBI, well, I don't know if the FBI go to people's houses anymore. I've seen the cops go to people's houses, and it never turns out very well. There, it's very don't give people's numbers on my show. 917-719-5923 is where you could talk to me about anything. I'll talk to you.
This is Socrates, an eater of worlds and commander of the four winds. king of all dinosaurs. Kneel before me, Squibble.
Looks like we have a live one. Hello, caller. Welcome to Nick the Rat.
Hello, Nick the Rat. I just want to let you know, I don't judge you by the color of your fur, but by the content of your balls.
Oh. Well, I could show you the content of my balls. Wait, no. This isn't my OnlyFans. This is, it looks like we have another live one calling in right now. Hello, caller. Welcome to the show.
Oh, hey, Nick.
Oh, my God. It's you.
Oh, yeah, it's totally me, the person that sounds like this.
Is this Dr. Crotch? Dr. Crotchula?
No, it's not. It's Fletcher trying to pretend to be Dr. Sir Mike Roach.
I thought it was the crotch guy. This Fletcher? How you
oh, doing? Man. So I could have kept it up, and you would have thought, oh, man.
What? Wait, I'm still actually... Now I don't know if Fletcher's even real. Maybe... Wait, are you Dr. Crotchula? Are you Mike Crotch? Are you the
content? No, I wish I was a fucking doctor. Man... I would be waving that doctor badge all over the place.
Doctors could be being late right now, but they're not, because they can't.
They can't. I guess they can't. I don't know.
Because you can't meet people right now. You can't even meet people you know. Or it's like...
Yeah, that's true. You can't even meet people you know. How are people dating and stuff? Where are you supposed to, like, hey, baby, you want to, like... go out on Zoom sometime?
Well, yeah, it's going to cost you, though.
It's one of those.
Asking me, I'm sorry. Looking.
oh, wink, wink, nudge, nudge.
Well, at least
the
you could kick him out of your house faster.
Service.
You could get him out of your house faster.
Oh, that's true. Yeah, you don't have to, like... wait for them to get out of bed, go to the bathroom, get all their shit.
And you don't know if they're going to...
Oh, I forgot my shoes.
Are they staying the night? Do they want you to make breakfast? Did they call the cops on you? It's a very risky situation.
It is, but Zoom, you just hang up. If they're like, why'd you hang up so abruptly? Oh, connection problems and shit.
Especially if they ever fucking talk about my mom wearing her nightgown.
Who the fuck says that shit?
It might have been Dr. Crotchula, but...
Oh. Oh. I couldn't believe that guy talking shit about your artwork, too. Like No Agenda picks your art because you're their buddy or something.
Did you see? Did you see it on No Agenda Social or Twitter? It was different people.
I saw it on No Agenda Social, and it took a lot for me to not comment. I was like, nope, I'm not gonna say anything. I'm just gonna let it go.
Maybe I should read Adam Curry's response. It was pretty badass. Actually, Darren O'Neill jumped
in.
It
was pretty badass. It was.
Where is it? Let's see, Adam. Curry. I hate that I'm saying actually. Like, I actually. It's a filler shit I'm saying, and I hate when I do that. Also, as one. Okay.
We all do it.
Yeah, for real. It happens. You just start saying stuff that is very repetitive. But I did not know the name of the show that Adam was talking about, the Catherine the Great show. I was looking for it on Amazon, and there was like 500 fucking Catherine the Great shows.
So it's on Hulu.
Yeah, I know. Did he say that on the show?
He might have, because that's when I started watching it, was when he talked about it on No Agenda. I was like, well, I've seen this, but I've just skipped over it, so I guess I'll watch it.
I don't have Hulu, so the first place I looked for it was on Amazon, and there was like a fuck ton of different Catherine the Great shows. So I was watching one from like 20 years ago, and they were talking Russian, like, but I heard the Hulu one's like a comedy or something.
Yeah, yeah, and there's very little historical accuracy to the one on Hulu. It's a modern comedy, you know. I mean, the most historical thing is her name's Catherine, and she's married to Peter the Third.
Oh, man, I was watching one that had, like, straight up, like, real Russian speakers, and it might have been real. I don't know. It was crazy. But, so I had to message him, like, what the fuck? Okay, here it goes. So this Sir Saturday Night, that's his name. Sir Saturday Night, he posted, it's probably comic strip blobber.
His alter shit-talking ego.
It probably is. So he messages John and Adam. He's like, here's my No Agenda cover art. He puts this on No Agenda Social. I present to you my show cover. He's like...
like, doing it that way, like adding John and Adam, or either or both, is a surefire way to make sure they ignore it.
I know, it's like, to both of you, directly, this is my artwork for this show. I call it Guernica Black Floyd. And the colorway of the race implication, some shit. He just says a whole bunch of stuff in like Greta, and he links to it. Okay, so he doesn't get picked. DC Chris, or Dr. Chris, says, this is brilliant. Dr. Chris liked it. That's cool. And then he gets mad. He's like, too bad they didn't pick it. They went with a flash in the pan meme over a cover that is actually named the guy our current PSYOP is about.
Well, see, that's what happens when you put too much thought into something like crazy. That. It doesn't come across. I mean, you're making an image.
It has to
be
general.
And then you're trying... Yeah, well, you have to be able to convey the thought in such a way that other people can pick up on that thought. And he clearly didn't do it. It's like,
it's
well, I saw it and I was just like, what is, like, Dark Side of the Brown? I'm like, okay.
That's what I saw too. It's like a rainbow with no colors. Like, you're just taking
I thought he was just trying to say, like, you know, you put, like, white light in and you get shit out. I didn't know what he was trying to say. Like, different shades of shit.
I don't know. But did you see the Mike Riley one with the two geese?
Yeah. And the microphone between them?
Yeah. Like, somebody called that clip art. I'm sure Mike Riley did not use clip art to do that.
That was Martin JJ that called it clip art.
Really? Man.
Yeah, but he was all sneaky about it and did the post in Dutch.
I was about to say he's Dutch. Those Dutch people.
Yeah. Yeah, these Dutch people trying to sneak it in with their secret fucking dyke language.
These Americans, they don't know how to use translate.
I do.
But either way, Adam put him on blast on the show because he was like, somebody called it, now you just put him on blast. Ooh. I'm starting
to. Oh, I guess I did. I doxed him because Adam called him some rando.
Yeah, Adam said
like,
he's
Martin
a rando.
Martin JJ's not a rando.
Yeah, he's Martin JJ. He's been around for a while. But, yeah.
Yeah, the dude, like, did such good artwork, he just stopped. He's like, I'm tired of winning.
Mike Riley does great stuff, and it's all, like, original drawings. Like, he actually draws everything out, I think. He might not be, but
I wonder.
I can tell a non-drawn from a drawn. I think it is.
Well, I wonder if he traces.
Eh.
I mean, I'm not knocking Mike Riley because he does like really badass stuff. But
yeah,
there was one with like it was an animal or something hanging out of the white Bronco, OJ's white Bronco.
Oh, the tiger hanging out the Bronco.
Yeah. Yeah, the Bronco looked like he had taken a Bronco image and just traced over it and then colored it in and made his own. I mean, it's still his. He does way better shit than
inkers, man. Those inkers. Oh, man, I'm going to not dox this person, but I know a couple of artists out there. I think I have a decent eye for art. Is it really? I don't know. I don't like modern art. I hate that shit. You ever go to a modern art museum and it's like a blank canvas and they're like, this is incredible. Maybe I'm an asshole, but I can't appreciate it very much.
It just seems bogus because that's the same way of you have an idea that you want to convey to people, but you're doing it in such a way where the idea isn't, it doesn't come across. Like, a blank canvas, what am I supposed to get from that? Is that a polar bear in a snowstorm? What am I looking at?
No, it's the strokes. It's the strokes he put into the canvas. And okay, you know what? I see it as like small batch. It's like a small batch. It's like, oh.
I got some strokes for him.
But what I do for no agenda art, some of the times a lot of art, it's not a lot of work. I do collages. I grab images and I blend them together. And I do some color. I know a lot about different art parts, but I try to just do something fast that I could do. That is, it's mostly collages though. I think Mike Riley does a lot of actual hand drawn stuff. Darren does collages as well. I think I'm not gonna pigeonhole.
He does great though too. He does some original designs too. Darren is so quick about it. Like, he cranks those things out. He'll have, like, you know, five or six for each episode.
I can't do more than two. Like, after I hit two, I'm like, I'm gonna... Oh, people used to complain,
I tried doing it, like, every little idea. I burnt myself out. Now I don't even do them.
Well,
but I was doing stuff.
You're like a musician. You're not like a musician. You are a musician.
And the art thing is just fun.
Yeah. Like, I can't make music for the show.
So in that case, music. I'm like an artist. I'm imitating one. I'm not really one, but I'm imitating one.
You got selected before, though. But it's...
Oh, yeah. Yeah, and then John takes a dump on it. He's like, oh, yeah, but it was the only one.
Don dumps on everything, man.
That is true, and I kind of took it as a compliment, because if JCD's not dumping on you,
if
then
he's
what
talking
are you
about
doing
you,
with your life?
It's almost like he's talking. He just mentioned me, so that's good enough. Even if he is dumping, because all he does is dump anyway. He's incredible.
Yeah, it's from a place of love. I'm dumping from a place of love.
And I also told Adam that they must get a lot of flack on the internet, because they give their opinion about some stuff, a lot of stuff, and I don't agree with all of it. And when I don't agree with it, I'm like. Like, oh, I think John is a womanizer.
You think?
Because whenever a woman does something messed up,
you can hear the change in his tone of voice when he's like, oh, and then a woman says this.
I don't know if he really changes his voice though, but the fact that
sometimes
he
does.
But he does it for guys too, though. He does say, this guy or this. Maybe I am the womanizer and I'm just noticing that he says it, or maybe he is saying, I don't know what it is. Maybe, but I don't know. Or is he just trying to do it to make people like crazy like me think about, is he?
It could just be doing it to rile people up because he knows it works.
Maybe. And like, how could you?
There's no such thing as bad press.
You're a Fletcher.
Yes.
When you say like something kind of like factual, how could it ever be wrong? You sound like a guy.
And then this guy, this Fletcher guy.
Like, if you got mad at me, what are you gonna be like? He called me a Fletcher guy. If you write it down, if you could write it down and it looks stupid, but when you say it, it sounds bad, it's you get away with it. This is the power of the pen.
And then there's this Nick character. He's a rat or some shit.
You're an asshole.
Doing art and stuff. He just dips his tail in like ink and fucking paint shit. I don't know.
I wish. You know what's really weird? I'm going to give you a little insight into Nick the Rat. I used to draw other stuff too, but for the past ever, it's only been rats. It's so weird. And it sucks because it's very limiting. And it's not even like rats. It's like this one shape. It's like I draw the same shape over and over and over again. And then for No Agenda, I do like collages. I feel like a hack.
Well... But you do the rat it's identifiable too whenever I see it. I'm like, that is Nick the Rat's rat. There's a lot of triangles in there, and those are neat shapes.
Some geometry. What's your favorite musical instrument? Is it voice? Is it vocal? Is it guitar?
No.
Is it a brass or a woodwind?
No.
It's your balls.
So, like, you mean just in general, like the a musical instrument that is the most expressive?
Like your go-to.
To me, my go-to is guitar, just because I've been playing it the longest.
Gotcha.
But if it's something I want to listen to that, like, moves me, then it's music with flute.
And have you ever played the flute?
Have I what?
Have you played the flute? Because you're a great guitar player, and your vocals are amazing. And you're
I'm trying to teach myself the flute. I have one because I work at a music store, so it's easy for me to acquire instruments. And yeah, I have a flute that I'm trying to teach myself to play. I have to play them well enough to know if they work or not.
Yeah.
So I can do that. But I want to be able to, like, fucking play it the way I like to hear it, where it's an evocative instrument that makes people feel the feelings that I want them to feel, you know. I can do that with guitar, and
but you want to do it with flute. You want that woodwind. You want to blow on that long rod and change people's lives.
Yeah, I want to finger and blow on that long rod and make people feel what I'm fingering.
I have a question that might help you find your answer.
Oh. Okay.
So fucking filler words, suck it. I want to throw my beer at the wall, but I'm not that crazy. fuck these filler words. I've been learning the ukulele.
Oh yeah,
the uke. But I think I've been learning something called chords.
Yes.
So there's chords, which there are like four or five of. There actually might be more, but those aren't the, like, the lyrics. Does that make sense?
Yes. The chords are the...
are like the...
the structure, the basis. So, like, the
so
melody or, like, the lyrics reside in the chords. The chords make up
they're like
the blueprint.
They're not the foundation. The foundation's like the bass, right? It isn't like the boom, boom, boom.
Technically the bass is part of the chord. Like, you get a bass interval in that chord. Root
but
notes.
There's less bass than chord usually. Or is this like music theory? Are we getting, like, deep in there now?
Oh, yeah. I was diving on in there. I was like, well, actually, Nick, if you want to get technical with it.
I do want to get technical with it. Because once
yes,
you start
because,
to, like...
the chord is made up... it just depends on what type of chord you're playing to.
Hmm.
I mean, you're getting deep in there, or I am, but no, the bass notes or bass line is part of that chord structure, where the chord really is like the foundation for the music, and that's why it's really obvious when somebody that can't sing tries singing over some pretty chords. You're like, oh shit, they're way out of key. That's because the chords are making up that structure that they should be centered around.
Of where they should be, and then there's where they actually are, which could be...
what's interesting about the ukulele is the way the strings are laid out, where you have that high string, and then, you know, it's like ding doom doom doom.
My dog has
fleas. The notes on the ukulele strings.
Bop, bop, bop.
That tuning, that way of laying the strings out, is like a medieval way of stringing an instrument.
I think that's why I like it.
That's carried over from the... that's the way they used to string guitars.
Well, there's four strings. Guitars have six usually, right?
Yeah, but guitars, they used to have, I forget the word, where you press two strings at the same time.
A power
guitars
chord.
Had nine strings.
Whoa.
Well, no, it had nine strings, and four of those strings are like, they were sets, so like a set of two, and you push two down at the same time. And it made the chords sound bigger and fuller, like playing on a 12-string guitar.
Yeah.
You play it like a 6-string, but you press down 2 strings at the same time.
So it's like,
and
two,
these
actually,
old medieval guitars were like that.
So what you're trying to say is they had like two extra guitars stacked on top of each other, sort of. And you could go like,
yeah. And do you know what a mandolin is?
That's
for like bluegrass music.
That's how you shave your onions.
It's the same thing. It's you press down it's 12 strings at the same time.
So yeah, and you only stroke 6 of them. You stroke 6 of the 12, and you hold down 2 of those.
You hold down 2 at the same time, so you play it like you're playing 6, but because you're doubling up on the notes, they sound bigger and fuller.
Okay, I have a lot of trouble with my strumming. So when you strum the 12 string, would you hit all 12? And only hold down 2?
Yeah.
Damn. Okay.
Yeah.
So that's like, wow.
If you're having trouble with your strumming, like keeping rhythm, is that what you mean? Like when you strum, you have a, like, is it difficult to keep the rhythm?
Okay, well,
or is it just difficult to hit individual strings?
I will tell, do you want to know where I have my mental block with music?
Mm-hmm.
With ukulele in mind, I play a lot of woodwinds. You're having a woodwind problem or flute problem. I like flute and tin whistle, because flute and tin whistle are the words of the song, and I'm seeing that ukulele and guitar are like the chords of the song. It's not the top part; it's like the middle part. And when I've learned the ukulele and the strumming, it's like you have to hit all of the. It's my dog has fleas, but it's all together. It's my dog has fleas. My dog has fleas, and you go up and down. You go up and down, and it's like don't go. But I like the Mr. Summer. I like the boop boop boop. The flute part or the words as
the melodies.
Melody. Okay, there we go. You're blowing my mind. It's stuff that I know that I don't know.
Yeah. Helped me get a grasp of that, of like the rhythm part, where you have to listen to the music to get underneath the melody that the singer's singing or the lead guitar is playing or whatever, to hear the chords.
Yeah. You could do
playing
chords,
air guitar.
You could do chords on the ukulele though, can you?
Yeah.
That's when you play like one string at a time. Or is it not?
On the ukulele, the one string at a time, like that, you're talking about the melody. If you're playing all the strings at the same time and you're making your... Yeah.
That I haven't learned yet. I only know how to do chords on a... But on a flute, I only know how to do melody. I don't know how to do the... But that's all the
same. Well, you can't play chords on a flute. You would need more than one flute player, you know, and have like a flute choir.
And that is my mental issues. That part, what you're saying right there. Like a flute isn't, you can't do 4 people at once. You can't do the boom, 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 boom as a chord. It's strange. does that
well,
make sense
if you,
to you at all?
If,
or am I
do you have a, no, it makes sense. I'm trying to think of how to explain it to you. Do you have like a chord book or a lesson book or something you're looking at?
Well, yeah, I'm looking at chords for, I know the bottom string, it's like A, I know a G, and like an F and an A, and a couple of, you know, but those are still like notes though, but they're chords. On a guitar, it's like a constant strum. You're not hitting, there's different layers of music. It's pretty crazy. There's a lot to know.
It is a lot to know. What kind of ukulele do you have? Do you have the small one, like a little soprano ukulele?
It's a soprano. It's like a $50-$60, you know, a little ukulele.
Oh, yeah.
String.
They got all different sizes of them.
Well, yeah. Well,
you could get like a baritone ukulele.
I'm not good with... I finally learned those 4 chords. And I'm trying to put them into a song, you know, just do a song, but you can't really do a song on the chord. The chords, when you do them, they don't sound like a song to you. So I can't,
it starts sounding like a song when you start singing on top of it.
Yes, you have to add the melody. Is singing melody or is singing above melody?
No, you're singing the melody part. Yeah.
Okay, so melody is the singing. So when you use your voice, that's melody. Can you use? You can't use your voice or chords, can you?
Well, like a barbershop quartet is a good example of using voices for chords. Because those guys, it's usually like five guys, and they're all singing individual parts. And then those individual parts make up the chord that you're hearing.
So that's why we don't have that today, because you need five people to be in wavelength with each other to do.
Yeah, you need five people that can all sing.
And these days we have a robot that might be able to be programmed to sing.
Yeah, we got robots that sing and actual people that mumble.
it's algorithms over mumbles. So it's not even natural. There's got to be barbershop. Why do they call it barbershop corp? Do they give haircuts too? Like, we're four guys. Do your hair, your nails.
Well, that's what. Because I guess the way they would dress is what I'm guessing. Or they were either standing outside the barbershop just singing shit to people.
They're like ancient rap artist standing outside of the barbershop singing together.
That's music's weird, man. And what's even weirder about music is they call it music theory for a reason.
Because it's all
subjective. You might hear a chord in a different way than I hear it, but we both acknowledge the fact that you're playing a G major, but you know you're hearing something different than I am.
Do you know how I see
that? It's like colors.
Yeah,
you know, we all agree that red is red, but is it really?
Yeah, it usually is. I think it usually is. I think I'm more right than I'm wrong, and that's why my wavelength is more generalized for the color red. But it's not very tuned. Actually, I think my ear is good for music. It's just that I can't create it very well.
Well, no, I think you can. It's about getting over your hang up. It's like a blockage in the sewer pipe. It's not letting the stuff flow.
I'm lazy.
Well, that's probably it too.
Yeah. It's laziness. Well, like, how's your flute coming? Have you ever played the tin whistle?
Is that the little small one, but it still has holes in it?
Got six holes. Pretty small. It's like a recorder, but smaller and not as childish. Oh. Recorders are super childish.
Yeah.
Why are recorders so childish? The tin whistle should be the childish.
Well, the recorders made of plastic are childish. There are some really high-end wooden recorders that sound amazing.
Yeah, the cheapest wooden tin whistle I've seen was £80, which is like $80, I guess.
There's this one recorder we have at the shop that was, I don't remember when it was made. It was made in like the 40s, the 30s or 40s, but it was made in England. Yeah. And it's like this recorder that they use to play Baroque music on. Are you familiar with that Led Zeppelin? Well, are you familiar with like that Led Zeppelin song, Stairway to Heaven?
Yeah. You know what's so sad, though? If you ask me to play it to you in my way, I don't... Stairway to Heaven. No.
Now we're doing mashups.
Can you remind me? Because, like, I know it. I know Stairway to Heaven. It's AC/DC? Or is it...
It starts off with a D chord. Dun-dun-dun-dun-dun-dun-dun-dun-dun-dun-dun-dun-dun-dun-dun-dun-dun-dun-dun-dun-dun-dun-dun-dun-dun-dun-dun-dun-dun-dun-dun-dun-dun-dun-dun-dun-dun-dun-dun-dun-dun-dun-dun-dun-dun-dun-dun-dun-dun-dun-dun-dun-dun-dun-dun-dun-dun-dun-dun-dun-dun-dun-dun-dun-dun-dun-dun-dun-dun-dun-dun-dun-dun-dun-dun-dun-dun-dun-dun-dun-dun-dun-dun-dun-dun-dun-dun-dun-dun-dun-dun-dun-dun-dun-dun-dun-dun-dun-dun-dun-dun-dun-dun-dun-dun-dun-dun-dun-dun-dun-dun-dun-dun-dun-dun-dun-dun-dun-dun-dun-dun-dun-dun-dun-dun-dun-dun-dun orders come in? That's what I was getting at. The bass player plays these really fucking fancy recorders, and it's really nice and pretty sounding.
Oh, those
You're
are
like,
recorders.
Wow, what instrument is that? It's a fucking recorder.
Nice. Man, I would have been like awesome to be in their recording studio. What were they like? Do you have any idea?
Who?
Stairway to Heaven.
Led Zeppelin?
Oh, Led Zeppelin. See how I ignorantly asked you the question to figure it out? Like, I know Stairway to Heaven. I know Led Zeppelin. But I said AC/DC, which is wrong.
AC/DC, like, if you're talking about the ukulele and playing, like, G, C, and D, if you know G, the G chord, the C chord, and D chord, those three chords, you can play just about any AC/DC song.
You could, okay, do you know what really, okay.
And throw in an E minor for good measure.
Ignorant point of view, completely, because I'm completely dumb, okay. But I didn't learn about music until my friend, it was like in junior high school, it was like, you could do any song over any, I guess it's any melody. Wait, not melody, it's the step down. You could do any song over like any chord or something like that.
Yeah, well, like certain a lot of music just uses the same chords.
Well, because there's not that many, because it's like everything like boom, 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 boom.
Well, there's some Christmas song that uses the exact same chords as that Twisted Sister song. We're not gonna take it.
But yeah, but if you play the chords, you it could be like, oh, that's one of 500 things. If you do the melody,
yeah.
The melody is like, that's the melody of that one song. And that's where my mental hookup for creating music is. I know I could do the, it's just me thinking about it. It's weird. It's fucking weird, man.
You can fake it. I used to be that guy that would show up at parties with the acoustic guitar.
And be like, yeah,
and like
I'm
play.
Cool.
And I would just like make up these. Like, I would just play jazz chords that are like 7 and 9 and 11 chords and just play them in any old order and then just start singing rap lyrics.
And you would have people,
and people
are
like, that's
you.
Brilliant. And I'm like, nah, I'm just making up shit because I'm drunk.
It's it's improv. It's like musical improv. And when you do it live, it's interesting.
Especially if everybody else is drunk and high.
Well, of course, improv is
always.
You got to
play to your audience.
Yeah. Well, I sort of don't agree with you. I think improv of any sort is liked by any group. If you were to, okay, like Louis C.K., he's known for his comedy, but if he whipped out his and started masturbating, I think the whole room would notice.
Yeah, that's true. That's true.
Oh, if you whipped
out
your
guitar, don't
worry,
guys. This is just part of the show.
Some people might like it, and they're like, "Wow, he did that real well." But then there's going to be people that are going to leave and not enjoy it. Just like every other form of. I'm going to have a beverage. How are you doing tonight, Fletcher?
I'm doing pretty darn well.
Nice.
I'm wondering where I set my beer.
What are you drinking tonight?
A Modelo. Especial.
Nice. I like Modelo. I like. What's your least favorite beer? I could tell you my least favorite beer.
What's your least favorite beer?
Bud Ice.
Oh, yeah. That's on up there. That's up on the list. Steel Reserve is on that list for me.
Steel Reserve is so much better than Bud Ice.
I don't like.
Yeah,
I don't like Michelob Ultra.
Really, you don't like Michelob? I kind of not dislike that one. It's very hard to displease me, but
I don't like any of the beers that are like whatever type of beer with lime.
You gotta add the lime in. What's your favorite beer?
Oh.
Or any of your.
Well, it was. My favorite beer was Newcastle Brown Ale until they changed the recipe in the States.
Really?
I don't know if it's still the same in jolly old England.
Probably not. It's probably different. There's a shipping.
Well, it's changed hands so many times.
Yeah, that's true, too.
It was, like, originally made in Newcastle, then it was bought by some Dutch company. And now it's distributed in the U.S. by some Chicago company, and it doesn't even taste the same. It tastes like brown dirt water.
Do you like Guinness?
Mm-hmm.
So I've been to Ireland, and Guinness was pretty good there too.
I bet it was good there. How did they serve it?
The same way you get it anywhere else. Next to curly fries. It's they're much more musical over in Ireland, and the scenery was much more beautiful. And but they're more against smoking. They're very non-smokers there, I think. They're drinkers, but they're not much on the smoking side. Kind of like Louisiana. Louisiana, New Orleans are huge drinkers. Have you ever been to Louisiana?
Oh yeah. Well, I'm right next to it.
Yeah, you're close by. Yeah, I'm closer than May for sure.
I go there quite a bit. They have cheap cigarettes in Louisiana. That's for sure. And the people do enjoy the drinking. I don't think they do it anymore, but the casinos used to give you free alcohol just for showing up.
Wow. Don't bring me there.
I would drive to Shreveport just to go to the casinos and drink. I would take like a coffee can full of change, take it to the casino lady and be like, I want, you know, this much in change or coins or whatever. And they'd cash it out, give you a little card, and then you can stick that card in machines and just drink till you are drunk. And then some.
I like the end some part. Caller? Fletcher? John, the amazing John. I can't, does it... Man. Do you know what is strange about life? If you give... Well, there's a lot. Yeah, okay. Well, actually, you know what?
Yeah, it's like...
What is your, in life, what do you think is the strangest thing that we go through? There's a lot of, life is strange, right? Like, I'm talking into a piece
life
of metal.
Life is really strange. Yeah, and how it seems that we can shape our own reality just by really thinking and concentrating on something.
I think
we do it.
Shaping reality.
Or then it happens.
I think there's chords, and I think there's melody, and there's bass to reality as well. Because there.
Yeah, I mean it is. It's the same thing, and you have to first be able to identify it in life, and then focus your mental energy on either if you want it changed to change it, or if you want to be part of it to make it. Where it welcomes you and lets you be part of it. Life is weird.
Become part of the song.
Just the fact that we're even here, I'm a walking meat sack that's suspended by, you know, bio sticks. Like that's all my bones are. It's just biologically made sticks and they're holding my muscles and body together.
And it depends
and then
on what you consume,
too. That body has, thoughts where I think about other people's bodies and bones and their thoughts. And their thoughts affect my thoughts and mine theirs. And then we have pets. We have animals that we're like, you're mine now. I'll feed you. You just let me touch your fur.
I could tell you something. It's, actually, you know what? I can't tell you anything yet.
You could tell me anything.
I could, but I also can't. I could though.
That's true. Everybody's listening.
It's true. There's some private conversations I would love to have with you, Fletcher. But I love our public conversations.
We'll have to do that in person. That way, we're certain nobody's listening.
Oh. Gonna be a great time when we finally meet one day. Can we listen to a song really quick? You can hang around for us.
Do
want.
A song.
A song. Songity dong dong. I gotta go to the bathroom. I gotta play some music.
Oh yeah, we'll play the song. I'll get off of here and let people enjoy your great wonderful show.
Yeah, get the hell out of here, Fletcher. Let other people use the phone
line. I'm sorry. Yeah, I know.
I gotta
it's
hang
my
up
fault,
on you. Hold
and
on.
I apologize.
Where's the hang up button? Hang
up.
You can call back later. Bye. There we go. Ba-da-da, ba-da-da. I don't know if you heard that. We're going to listen to some musical interlude. This is a False Lives by The Midnight. River of Dark. River of Dark. We're going to be back with more Nick the Rat Radio. Thanks for staying tuned in. Thank you, Fletcher, for the conversation. We'll be back with more whatever we want in the SS sewer sub.
Yeah.
this fucking thing. I'm so happy that I am able to pilot this masterful piece of equipment. I just want to say thank you to the scientist of the Dark Sword Network for not checking up on my captain's license, because I don't have one. I've never steered this thing before, but, you know, I've been on an intergalactic spaceship before. I only crashed once, and that's why I'm here. Anyway, let's get back to our refreshments. But don't worry, if you're feeling like a pussy and you don't want to get drunk or stoned, we also have some apple juice, Doritos, and carrot sticks. So you can stick to those. I won't tell anybody if you don't, you know, it's fine. I'm not judging you. Only you could judge you. You know what I mean? If I judge you, you're going to forget that it even happened anyway. Next week, you'll be like, oh, what happened? I don't know. Doesn't matter. If you're lucky, maybe the captain will put the sub in auto drive and come into the passenger cabin and give every passenger a super sexy lap dance. I just learned how to do the Macarena, and I just learned also how to do the Nene. I've been watching this horse dancer instructor on Pornhub. Great stuff, so I know how to do that now. Well, anyway, let's get back to the hunt. I'm sure you're enjoying the ride. It's gonna cost you a lot of money to be on this fucking boat, Nick. It's gonna, the fuel prices, actually, it's kind of low right now. I don't know, the market's all over the place right now. So, you know, just strap in, strap on, enjoy the ride. We'll be finding some monsters soon, I'm sure. I really fucking hope so. Let me look at this map over here. The X is over here, and I think we're over here. There's, okay. You know what? Fuck that map. Let's just fucking go by instincts. We're gonna find this monster, I promise you. I fucking hope so. Anyway, Zindu. Out.
Hi, everybody. We're deep under Lake Champlain right now, looking for monsters. Why are we looking for monsters? That's always weird when you're out looking for. Hold on, man. They gave me some Sailor Jerry's and some coconut water. I feel so cool right now. The people in the chat room are calling me champs. They really enjoyed that last conversation we had with Fletcher. I have a lot of questions. I could talk to Fletcher for forever. But I could talk to anybody forever as well. By calling me at 917-719-5923. We could have conversations about anything. Like right here. Hey Nick, why doesn't my VPN work right now? Let's look at another. That's a little complicated. Maybe we should play some advertisements. We had a lot of donations before. I don't think we have any new donations. People usually do. They might donate during the show, which is always lovely. It's a sign that you enjoy the Wait, where are we? We're hunting monsters right now. People, the water. Who here likes to go into the ocean? Raise your hand. I'm the only one in the submarine. Me and Zindu. And I'm not raising my hand. I think going the ocean, it's fucking scary. You're out there. You're riding. You're on your boogie board. It's a wave machine. Why not have a wave machine? If you really love the ocean, you could buy a wave machine somehow, right? Can you? Is there like a something that's not out in the water that has fucking sharks or leeches or your friend Joe Bob's fucking piss or something? The water's 60 degrees, but it's raised up to 70 for a hot minute, and you're standing very close to me, and I saw you drinking that Gatorade earlier. That's not water no more. That's not. And then when you take your boogie board in, and then the sand crabs come out of the fucking sand every time that the water pulls back, and you see all those bubbles, where are those bubbles coming from? It's coming from little living creature, little crabs. Little crabs are coming up. It looks like we have another live one. Let's see what they have to say. Hello. You've reached the lines of Nick the Rat Radio. How are you doing tonight?
I'm doing well. How are you?
I'm doing so good. I have to ask you one question, though. Can you turn down your radio?
I've got it turned down.
How low do you have it?
Mute.
That's pretty fucked up. You shouldn't say mute on Nick the Rat. Well, you can call it back, but before then, we have to discuss the really important facts of this last voicemail. That's what life could be.
Hey, Nick. This is Kevbot's son, Evbot, and I'm calling in today with a joke.
Ooh, I got a joke? Ooh, nice.
How can you spot a gay man in a nude beach?
I don't, how?
It ain't hard. Call me back.
Hello, caller. Is this Kevbot's son?
Is this who?
This is Nick the Rat. Who are you?
I have my radio totally silent.
Silent is acceptable. X.
Silent. I won't say the M word.
Good. Because I forgot what it was. Don't remind me.
I was calling to warn you about Champ.
I'm the champ. Number one, baby.
No, there's...
Taiwan, number two.
Have you ever heard the Call of Cthulhu?
Well, yeah, I know all about Cthulhu. And the old ones?
Champ is like Cthulhu.
What? What?
He is roaming Lake Champlain.
Wait, hold on one second. Caller, I think... I hear an echo.
Wait, you can hear an echo.
You muted it at the... I almost caught you.
I was going to say it twice, but then I was like, no.
Caller?
Do you know who Champ is?
I'm the champ. Number one podcaster.
Champ. You don't know No, that's not the champ.
Yes.
Champ is the monster of Lake Champlain.
You're saying I'm the monster of Lake Champlain?
No, Champ is.
That's okay, look,
watch
I know
out.
I'm here.
I keep hearing on your radio, you keep pinging him. You're bouncing the radar waves.
What are you
off
talking about?
I can hear it. And then when I hear it, like at the end of that little beep, it's like it says, Champ.
Are you?
Champ. Champ. Champ.
Caller. Are you having any beverages tonight?
I am having a two-hearted ale. By Bell's Brewery.
You almost said that in a very competent way. I salute you.
It's named after the river that Ernest Hemingway fished.
The writer fisted, you
the
said?
The writer.
Ernest Hemingway fisted a chick on the river that you're drinking beer
no,
from?
No. It's a river in the Upper Peninsula of Michigan called Two-Hearted. And this beer is named Two-Hearted Ale. It has a big trout on it, so it's a trout ale.
So Ernest Hemingway stuck a trout up his boyfriend's butt.
And came up with an ale, and it was beer.
That is...
In the world rejoiced.
That's actually what the drink I'm drinking smells like right now.
What's all, like Ernest Hemingway's ass?
Yes.
That doesn't sound pleasant.
It's not. It's pretty good. It's he must have been from the islands. He likes coconuts. It's very coconutty.
I heard that Hemingway did like a coconut every now and then.
So you seem to enjoy the anuses of writers. Are you illiterate?
Well, last time you were on, I was drinking a beer called Psychedelic Cat Grass.
Do you get your beer bites? Do you have an old favorite, or do you just drink new beers named crazy shit every week.
I had one way back. It was called Hazel's Nuts.
That's a way back joke right there. That's a good one.
You know what I'm saying, though? But Hazel's Nuts was delicious.
And we don't know the gender either, so they're fine all year long.
Did you ever... I've told you a joke before, but it was like Bruce Jenner. Or no, I'm sorry. Caitlyn Jenner was in Sports Illustrated.
What year?
This past year.
And you could see her
skirt.
Turn your radio down, caller. I hear that shit. That's not me.
It was nuts.
I have good ears. I'm a rat. I hear that. Your radio's on.
How do you have a red rat mustache?
Hi, everybody. We're talking about how my mustache is fine. We're on Nick the Rat Radio. Wait, it looks like Zindu is actually sending another call up front over here.
Captain Zindu here to save your asshole or something. We're currently in uncharted areas a few miles south of Ontario. So if I start saying A and talking like a Canuck or whatever they fucking do out there. You know they're strip clubs in Canada. You could spread your legs and let people inspect your caverns. I love Canada. Nick, I gotta take you up there again one day. I've been up there. I've been partying with some people. It's been a great time. We're about 300 feet deep now, just like I was in your mom last night. And this is the area of the lake. It's known to have contagious waterborne viruses in it, okay? So if you look under your seat, you'll find a mask, okay? It's a very loose, shittily woven mask. Don't worry about it, though, because if you feel the need to be safe, you could put it on now, okay? Just put the mask over your nose and your mouth right now. But wait, if you put it on too early, it's not going to work, okay? But also... If you don't put it on right now, you're gonna die. You gotta put that mask on right now. Right now, where you're going to die. Unless you have a clear mind and healthy lungs, then you don't have to worry about it at all. If you're healthy, you don't have to put the mask on. Because these things, actually, they'll actually make you stronger. You'll become stronger if you get these waterborne viruses inside of you. So just don't even look at the mask. Don't even look at it. If the person next to you isn't wearing one, don't be a dick. Just tell them to put it on, or you're gonna spit in their face. It's fine because if it's already actually in the cabin right now, and you actually might already be dead. This might be purgatory. This whole SS sewer sub ride might just be purgatory. But if you are still breathing right now, please stay away from your captain by at least three of Zindu's penis lengths. I know that's pretty far, but just stay away, at least that far. If you come any closer, I might shank you. And just remember that you must put the mask on right now. If you don't put the mask on right now, I will kick you out of the sub. But now just passed, so don't worry, don't put it on. Don't put it on the floor, because there are germs on the floor. And probably a lot of my piss and cum down there, too. So you don't want to put the mask on the floor. And please, please remember to stay safe back there. Okay, just stay safe. I love you. This whole ordeal is fine. We will be arriving at one of the most monster-filled areas of the lake shortly. Enjoy!
Thank you for the update, Zindu, captain of this SS submarine. I don't know about you people, but have you ever been on a submarine before? I was on a submarine once before in my life. This is my second time. But to be on a sub is weird. It's like you're at like a movie theater. like you're being operated on. Being on a submarine is like being operated on, because it's slower than jumping out of an airplane, which I won't do. I won't. Jumping out of an airplane is like being killed, and going in a submarine is something you could do to feel like you're at a museum that has interesting sights every 10 minutes or so. I think the air pressure down here is getting to me. Okay. Subs are tiny. Subs are very small. They're like, it's like a row of seats. It's like you're back to back with another group of people, and you're just looking outside at impending doom, and you're, if something springs a leak, which one of these people are you going to kill first? Like, because you need the oxygen, and there's like you and maybe one other person you know, and then about 10 people you don't know. And then those 10 people, who's the smallest person we could choke out first? And they would they'll be gone. And then the rest, there's the 8 people left that are fine. But then we have to look at the next person. Maybe it's somebody that's a little bit, it's like, I feel like the silent killer when I have these thoughts. I feel like that I am the person inside of the... We should maybe listen to a gas blast. Let's look if we have any emails. Gas blast. Now, is it one word? Is it two words? I'm not too sure. I'm looking at, this one's two words. What's it like to get a rim job in space? A rim job in space is probably horrifying and amazing. Horrifying. Because everybody's watching. If you... Okay, there's gotta... Not everybody. Okay, it's horrifying because there's a subset of about 20 to 1,000 watching. The same people that are giving you money. Imagine if the people giving you money to see your ass get an... eaten out was unknown. When you're a sex worker in the modern day, there's almost a scary... Okay. Here's something I was thinking about for a while. If you're a sex worker today, or a podcaster, I think podcasters and sex workers are almost the same thing today. If there's a direct connection between you and the creator, you have to trust that creator to not dox you. How much do you trust a random person than you trust the government from putting you on the news and having Ryan Seacrest laugh at you? You could trust Nick the Rat. We have advertisements. Let's listen to an ad from the Dark Sewer Network to keep the submarine working.
Sick of your rights being taken away? Start taking them away from others. Sick of being screwed by capitalism? Stop working and start begging. Sick of not having freedom of speech? Start taking it away from others. Sick of the government? Overthrow them and start your own! Order a black hoodie from the Dark Sewer Network! And for only $69.99, you can become the alternative revolution of your wildest dreams today!
Shut up. This ad is too loud. I didn't okay this. I didn't okay this advertisement. That was bad. Okay, how do we... Oh, shit. Sadly, they come in twos.
Hello, friends. Devil here. Sick of not being able to kill yourself legally? Thank me now, because you won't be able to later. My team of scientists and lawyers have worked years on this new product. It passes all safety inspections and is still guaranteed to kill you. It will rot your teeth, give you cancer, destroy your liver, ruin your blood, and make you gain weight. And if you drink enough of it, you will die. Pepsi Cola. Praise Keck. It's here and death has never tasted so sweet. Pepsi Cola. Even the way we produce and package it is killing everyone right now. But science and law is on Pepsi's side. Praise Keck, you are addicted to the flavor and brainwashed by our ads that keep you drinking. Pepsi Cola. And now, only on the Dark Sewer Network, can you buy a barrel of this shit for only $69.99. Call now and we'll even throw in a Shia LaBeouf sippy cup. 917-719-5923. Pepsi's got your taste for death. Tell them the devil sent you. Ah, 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 ah.
Hello? Hi. Welcome to alternative media, where it doesn't care if you don't. Number five is... Johnny Five still alive. Actually, this is named wrong. Wait, it's 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Alright, what is number five? One, two, three, four. Okay, this one's Hila Line 9. Let's see if this even works. Wait, we got a phone call coming in. Let's make it even longer than whatever. Hi, caller. This is Nick the Rat Robot. How are you tonight? Would you like to leave a message?
The message is just... be fucking cool to everyone you can, and don't be violent.
You could get taken advantage of, though. And you have to be violent sometimes.
Well, okay, that's what basic self-defense is, but you don't need to be a dick about it, you know?
Well,
you don't need to
break
off anyone's windpipe.
There is...
There
is a dick level.
Yeah, you can be a dick, but you don't need to be a dick. Just don't be a dick. That's all.
Do you know what's
just
scary, though?
Don't be a dick.
I can tell you the scary
what's
part.
What's that?
Okay, this is the, like, I 1,000,000% agree completely. But then there's the dick level. There's, like, the person that is a murderer that is past being a dick. They're like, you know what? I will kill you. And if you try to push the level to theirs... you're already dead because I never killed anybody.
Sure. But you gotta think, what would Vash the Stampede do? That guy carries a gun and he has extreme speed and accuracy with that thing. And that guy does not kill. You know?
Are you on Skype? What kind of connection do you have to the internet right now?
Oh, I'm on my shitty cell phone. It is a clam.
That's
but I'm also in the sewer chat.
Oh, you are?
I'm kind of looking at that.
Wait, yeah. Who are you?
Oh, hello from Spearfish. This is Stillwater. I forgot to say that.
Cheers to you, Stillwater. How are you doing, my buddy?
Oh, I'm doing great. I made myself a big bowl of spaghetti and meatballs. And I'm drinking some Cabernet Sauvignon.
Can I ask you about your spaghettis and meatballs?
Oh, yeah. It's got red tomato sauce with some fresh basil and some oregano. And, of course, garlic.
All right,
it is delicious.
Stillwater, I have to break down the question even further.
Okay.
I have to go deeper.
Is that okay? Go deeper into my bowl.
How deep can I go into your spaghettis?
Oh, as deep as you want. Ask anything you want about my spaghetti and the meatballs.
All right, my friend. Here we go. You are on Spaghettis 101 on Nick the Rat Radio. Is your pasta... Did you make your pasta? Or did you buy it in a box?
Well, I got a little package.
Did
I know
make
how to
a,
make
a
the...
Bag?
I know the
box.
Process of how to make your own nudes.
Oh, I do too.
And making your own fresh nudes is great. I love sending nudes. I love sending nudes to all the people that are hungry.
P.O. Box 5049?
This time I just got...
11209.
Yeah.
There you go.
This is just spaghetti. I don't know.
I'm getting deep into your spaghettis here. Okay, so what do you prefer there? Do you prefer boxed, bagged, or homemade?
Oh, I prefer homemade because it's got that you can taste the flavor of the wheat in it. It's like a very warm and full flavor.
Okay, well, can I go deeper? Because I'm a big pasta fan. Okay, so when you make it at home, what kind of flour do you use? Do you use bread flour? Do you use like ramen stuff, or do you use a whole wheat or basic bleached white?
On the rare occasion when I make the nudes at home, homemade. Yeah. I prefer the whole wheat, and
the
that's
whole
because
wheat.
I,
home nudes.
Yeah, yeah. I mean, like my whole some of my family are actual farmers, and we can get actual wheat that's been ground up and all that stuff, and so we can get it fresh from there, and then we mix that. You know, we make the flour out of that, you know, and then you get your egg in there and mix that up, and boom, it's homegrown.
Still.
And so if you're making it on that level, that's where you're going to get the most flavor.
Stillwater, can I ask you a lot of questions? How many questions can I ask you, Stillwater?
You can ask me as many questions as you desire, because I am a strange soothsayer, and I'll be saying some sooth to you.
I would love to have you soothe my says. Have you ever played a musical instrument?
Oh, yeah. In high school, I played the trombone, and I've also learned the guitar. I don't play either of those anymore, but I've, especially lately, I've been really into rocksteady and ska jazz orchestra.
When do you listen to it? What is your activity? What activity do you take while you're listening to these?
Oh, I'm usually at work. I force the kids that I work with to listen to my music, and they usually like it, you know. But
you're giving them variety. They would give you. Actually, you should find out what they would listen to, like at least one day a week, just to see what, like, you know.
Oh yeah.
What are you listening to?
I didn't understand Billie Eilish until these kids started making me actually listen to her music. And then once I figured out that what she's doing is like horror through pop music, kind of like how the Misfits did horror through punk rock, like that's when I was like, oh, all right, yeah. Oh, now I get it. All right.
There's a weird level of enjoying a person's artistic output compared to knowing the person's personal level. Okay, Billie Eilish, you like her music now, but if you met her in person, would you want to hang out with her? You might want
it to. It kind of depends on the context of how I'd meet her, because she comes off as a very creepy girl music videos. And if she had that kind of persona, like her stage persona, it'd probably freak me out. And I'd be like, ah, nice to meet you. I'm going to go over here now. But if she has like an actual like nice person kind of personality in real life, I'd probably be cool.
I never met her, and you never did either. Did you ever meet Fletcher?
No, not in person. I've talked to the guy before.
He's probably a jerk.
He didn't seem like a jerk to me, but he could probably be a bastard to anyone who deserves it. You know.
Hopefully.
You gotta look out for yourself.
You do.
He doesn't sound like a pushover by any means, but he sounds like a solid dude.
Stillwater, can I ask you a personal question that might make me feel better as a person?
Sure.
Have you ever felt bad about one of your personal actions towards another person? Food or anything? Have you ever felt? What was the last time you felt bad? Like the last action you did? What is the last thing you did that made you say, "Damn, I should maybe rethink not doing that again"?
Ooh, that's a tough one.
It doesn't have to be like, you know. It doesn't have to be like I killed.
No,
somebody,
nothing like super scary or anything like that. But
like I'm looking for small.
I can't think of a specific instance, but it's like. When I think about how I was back when I was a middle schooler, was a fucking douchebag back then. And it was like everything I did there.
Were you you or to other people?
It was mostly to myself, and then that kind of spilled over.
Now I could get you to the point where I'm trying to get you to be. So I want to find out the douche thing that you did to yourself during middle school.
Okay. Well, and you see, that really was the point in my life when I was finally able to convince my parents to take me off of Ritalin. Because I was prescribed Ritalin when I was 5 years old.
Oh.
And I always hated it. And so, it was like my body chemistry was fighting this extra chemical thing that was going on. And then, my older brother... I love the guy, but he was always kind of a dork, and so he'd get bullied at school.
Wait,
and then
how big of a dork was he? What kind of dork was he?
Yeah.
Holy crap. Still, I feel like...
We're getting deep into the Stillwater lore tonight, huh?
We can get deep into my lore, too. There was much stress in my life, and you had a stress too. Mm-hmm. But you also had drugs to help you through the stress, so fuck you.
I mean, I had good drugs, but they weren't the drugs that I wanted.
Oh,
I wanted
man. You were forced
to be myself.
Strange drug. So, are you and your brother still buddies?
Yeah, we don't talk all the time, but when we meet up, we're not like assholes to each other. We talk about things every now and again. But it was more like it was that adolescent phase. Where, that's an age when everyone is questioning themselves
we
and
are.
They don't know who they are.
We don't. And it sucks when the people that are helping you push you into a very strange situation. Which sounds like you were... I was pushed into a strange situation. We're all pushed into strange situations. And you would replicate that as well. Because there's no perfect timeline for anybody. All timelines have variation.
Well, and I think the reason no one has that perfect timeline is because you have to have those trials and tribulations in order to truly find yourself.
Indeed.
You have to overcome conflict to discover what kind of stuff you're made of. And so you have to go through all that bullshit to come out as a badass at the end of the tunnel.
But is it a badass that you want to be your final form? It's even weird to even think about the final form. I think about more of the now. I try to limit future predictions and past errors to to be now. I try to just try to get it to be like kind of like a loop, kind of like a track that's like a NASCAR track where they just go in like an infinity sign where the now keeps on going, and then you could kind of like shift the now to points you enjoy more. Like I might like to knit, so maybe I make more time for knitting.
Okay, you know, and like again, it's sort of like your past trials. Like it isn't just like if you want to be the kind of person that wants to knit on the side, so much as it's like you
want to knit forever.
Obstacles that you overcome help inform you how you're going to overcome the obstacles that are happening in the here and now. So, like, you know, things are kind of shitty right now, but it's like, okay, let's not worry about the past. Let's not worry about others. Let's worry about the small circle that I happen to have control over. Now, how am I going to deal with that?
Can I go to a deeper, scarier level for you?
Sure. Yeah, I'm down.
Stillwater? Sometimes I can't go to sleep at night.
Oh, whoa. Hey, that happens to me, too. It's crazy. And that's not just because Spearfish has been out of weed for a while.
Oh.
But, you know, there's a lot of worries. Like, I work with a bunch of kids over at Barbacoa's, and I even worry about some of them, too, you know? Because a lot, you know, they're in that age range where they're figuring out who they are, and sometimes they go out drinking, and I even worry almost as much as their own mothers.
Stillwater.
Yeah. That's me.
Do you ever tell these kids that they're going to die? They're going to die one day?
Oh, yeah. That's one of my favorite ones. Is, you know, hey, guess what? You're not going to live forever. And you should be okay with that. So you gotta live your life to the fullest right now.
Yeah, but that,
you gotta
live
that
might lead
life
to stupid decisions.
Well, yeah, but if you're gonna make stupid decisions, you might as well do it confidently.
That's true. What do you think you're gonna have for dinner tomorrow?
Tomorrow?
Yeah,
ooh.
Tomorrow. Dinner tomorrow. What is that for you?
I think tomorrow I'm going to head over to Killian's and get the perfect hamburger. I'm going to get an anarchy burger, hold the government, and then some fresh cut french fries.
That's too anarchistic for Nick the Rat Radio, everybody. We're going to hang up on that DB. If you would like to save that DB soul, give me a call at 917-719-5923. We're running real late tonight, and we should be able to get through it. Because we've had practice. Let's go to music. Moose. We got a... Lake of Memories with M-U-M-Y-U-U.
Thank you.
Wow, I made it back before the end. Ow. I gotta fix my headphones. There we go. We've been going for 11 to 12 to 1. We're almost 2 hours. 2 hours in? 3 hours in? We're gonna open the phone lines in a little seconds or two. Wait, do we have a... Do we have a voicemail? Or do we have a sewer... Gas blast. Let's look at the gas blast really quick. Gas blast. Do you hide your power level? If so, how? How do I hide my power level? I hide it any way possible. But I am usually too open to keep it hidden. So that's fine. But you know, I can hear myself a little bit better now. Jeez, it is so... We're so deep under the ocean right now. There's gotta be like... at least 45 PSIs... going on somewhere. Maybe. That's not a scientific number. Don't quote me on the PSIs of... 420. We're close between Vermont right now. Looking for the monsters, but there's not too many out there. Let's listen to a voicemail because nobody's calling me at 917-719-59. 2, 3.
917-719-5923. Why the hell is it beeping twice? I'll try again.
It's water for you. Water is the great equalizer. If you're ever feeling kind of shitty, I suggest water. Filtered is good. It's good to get it through the fine grain. Have you ever had what is it called when the light diffuses but it doesn't know where it's being seen? Like the light is like, I'm here, but I'm here, I'm here, I'm here. The observer light, like, it depends on what you're observing. And sometimes the observer might observe it, but then there's other times when the observer doesn't observe everything. They only see part of it, so it's not really real. Yeah. There's probably a link to Billie Eilish from who the fuck cares. I enjoy Billie Eilish, though, you know? But there's a lot of just be cool, relax everybody. Wait, we gotta relax. I might have a weird filter going on because I'm drinking water right now. 917-719-5923.
This is Kiwi _56. I am not a robot, as you can tell by the timbre of my voice.
Is that it? Is it working? Hello? Is this working? We are under Lake Champlain. We are relaxing on the Champlain Lake. And how we know we be relaxing under there? It is the pigeons telling us
the rats under the floor telling us that it is...
Oh shit, the light's going off. It looks like Zindo's gonna say something to us right now. Oh boy. Oh, I wonder what he's gonna say. Did we hear this?
I register Captain Zindo coming in to you, love. Just gotta let you know something right here. We're coming up to a very... Wait a second, wait. Okay, I just got this report in. It seems that Yellowstone might erupt soon.
What the fuck?
And the government thinks it's my fault, okay? They have canceled all future sub-rides after this one. So make sure you enjoy this fucking ride while it lasts, otherwise, because it's never... It might not ever happen again.
I will.
Okay, so it seems... They might have spotted me drilling in the area for pussy a few weeks ago, and I wish somebody told me that cats don't live underground there. I just thought that I might find a kitten. You know, what? But now they're blaming me for several earthquakes that are occurring in the area. It was like, there was like 11 or 12, you know, who's counting? It doesn't matter. It's just Yellowstone, and if it blows up and the whole world gets covered in soot and everybody dies, if that's my fault, people on Oktar are going to hail me as a hero. So, I think it's a win-win situation, basically.
LA?
I can't believe they're blaming me for that. But the strange thing is, they canceled me from doing any work ever again, but they also offered me a stimulus package of infinite tax-free money and children to do work for me. So I think this might be, I think I might have stirred up a little chaos, but, you know, well, anywho. I'm going to be buying a ton of stocks right now with my infinite dollar bills and fuck with the entire economy of the entire planet Earth. And I think, you know, if Yellowstone doesn't blow up, at least the stock market's going to blow up. I'm going to, I don't know if you've noticed, but the stocks are probably going up right now because I keep pumping more and more money into the system. It's fine. It's fine. Don't worry. That's not going to cause any issues later on down the line. It's just play money, right? You know, it's stimulus, funny money. There's a backdoor bank dealings going on. I'm not involved too much, but either way, I'm making out great. I'm making out a killing over here. You know, it feels good to have this sort of power. And if you look out to the right of the sewer sub right now, you'll see a largemouth bass jerking off on the window.
What? Whoa! Says, oh my god! Oh, that's fucking.
We'll be back with a
what the fuck? I don't see it.
Enjoy the ride.
All right, maybe we should listen to another song over here. We're going to go back to some radio songs. We got a Man on a Lake with New Soul featuring Murph Dirt. What the fuck? Murph Dirt? Not him. Please, not Murph Dirt. Oh, God. It looks like Murph Dirt is coming up. I can't. What? Why? Why Murph? This song is so old. Murph?
I'm a cuckold with two kids and I am fine with this, cause at least the miss hasn't come for pay. I drink Red Bull with my little green pill so I can feel like there is something left inside. Wait, I have no Valentine, cause when looking into my mind I only want to fuck to make her pay. So I eat my sutra line and write some shit that's asinine and fight myself to not throw it away.
Hey. Hey. Put, 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 put. But.
No
get on the green or putt. We're not using this ad lib track. Maybe make the ad libs louder than the verse. Are you gonna keep this whole in part? This is way too long. You should cut it off at some point.
Hi, everybody. You ever just want to give up? Want to fucking throw the towel in? I think we all have in many ways. Many times, I just want to throw the towel in. That is why I'm drinking H2O tonight. Welcome. Welcome to the H2O stream. This is... Oh, it looks like we have a caller. Let's see if they will not get hung up on. I think they might not. Hello, caller.
They will not.
Oh my God, your radio is so loud right now.
Okay, no, it wasn't.
Caller, how are you tonight?
It was loud, but I'm not going to admit that it was loud because I'm that caller.
Hey, that's all good. I already believed you after I convinced myself.
I believe in you, Nick the Rat.
I exist.
Every time I listen to your show, I hear that song from Karate Kid and Rocky IV. You're the best.
It's a good song, but...
No? Huh?
I like that. The song is great. Yes. I see why you think this.
It's the best song ever.
Now, I'm thinking of that song from Rad with the dirt bikes, the BMX bikes. There was the race. Send me an angel. Boo-doo-doo. You're the best. Eye of the tiger.
Eye of the Tiger is probably the best movie song ever, but...
There's a lot.
Like, that one, the first one that I talked about. The ones from Bloodsport, too, are all classics.
Oh, when Jean-Claude does the splits and punches some guy to
death.
But
it's all like that Asian music. It's all like, boom, boom, boom.
Was that like a metal? They did like a metal song for it. They're like, Bloodsport does the metal version.
Like the second or third one.
He's like playing drums, but it's really not.
And then when they do, every time they hit anybody, it's like they're like, goes like,
What's the craziest 80s movie you've ever seen? Is Bloodsport 80s or is that 90s? That's 80s, right?
No, 80s. That's definitely 80s.
That was
probably one of like the most cheesiest, because like the first one, they fought on like that. Do you remember it?
It was the first one, the Bloodsport?
Yeah, it was like the V-shaped like fighting ring, like it like sloped towards the middle. What? So like people had like height advantage in it. It was bizarre.
This sounds awesome. I've never heard of this. I think you're making it up.
No, I swear to God. I am like a child of the 80s.
A V-shaped ring to make short people bigger.
Slope towards the middle. Yeah, it was weird. I now when you watch it now, like back when I watched it when I was in the 80s, I was like, oh yeah, that's how they fight in Asia.
Did that happen in Cable Guy or Caligula?
Wait, what?
I'm trying to confuse you.
You confuse me with a Cable Guy and Caligula.
I'm just trying to see if I can do that.
Opposite realms of the spectrum.
Well, yeah, because I've never heard of what you're talking about, so I'm trying to make sure
The first Bloodsport movie. If you ever watch it,
Jean-Claude Van Damme, was he in it? There's the first.
Yeah. Yep. That was like his first. Like, hey, this is me in a movie that he ever made was Bloodsport.
Well, yeah,
and they fought on a on a mat that was angled towards the middle of the mat. It was like on ramp.
Was it like when you go to like the Museum of Science and they like have that weird perceptive room or whatever it's called?
We're it looks like you're closer on one side than you are on the other.
Did she make Jean-Claude Van Damme's fist bigger with the camera angles?
And then every person that he ever fought, like, he had some sort of evil angle where they had like some sort of chemical in their underwear.
That would be
they,
a
like,
great
in
movie.
His eyes, like, and they had to fight like blind.
There should be a mental fighter movie. The last mental fighter movie had Jean-Claude Van Damme in it. It was the Sandman. Do you remember the movie
with Jean-Claude?
With Jean-Claude Van Damme beating up a guy in jail that was like the Sandman, like he was in your dreams. It was like a dream fighter, and Jean-Claude Van Damme.
Oh, I remember that. Yeah.
What?
That was after the Dennis Rodman Jean-Claude Van Damme movie. There was a Dennis Rodman Jean-Claude Van Damme movie.
Why does this exist in our heads?
I'm in Detroit, so Dennis Rodman is drilled into everybody's head.
I remember him. How could you? Also, what do you forget though? What is something? What's the last thing you forgot?
The last thing I forgot? Wow. Yes.
That's a good question.
I can't remember.
Also, why would you embarrass yourself with that? Because it was probably something stupid. Like, what's mustard? I know what mayo is, but...
Mustard's the best condiment ever.
Mustard's broccoli.
Mustard is the king. It's like the king condiment. I don't know why I think that. I think it's because of my close relationship to Chicago.
Was it really windy there? How windy was Chicago?
Chicago is damn windy.
Did you have like one of those wind fans like at your window? And it was like, shit, like it's 70 miles per hour is out.
Chicago was like 10 miles an hour, like everybody's like, oh, it's not too bad today. But you're like, holy
that's like
crap,
the normal.
It's like blowing sand on my face.
The thick crust pizza. That's why the pizza had such thick crust. It was the sand extra.
But it's not sand. It's like...
No. I mean...
Street yeast. Grime or whatever.
It's just deep dish. What's the cheapest pizza you ever had in Chicago?
In Chicago?
Yeah.
Well, it's from my hometown.
Well, either way, what's the cheapest pizza you ever had in your life? Was
Little
it Ilio's?
Caesars.
Little Caesars.
Little Caesars.
Cheap in flavor or
that,
cheap in
that
price?
That guy's a legend in Detroit. Little Caesars is a legend in Detroit.
did you have dreams of a little fucking Caesar? With a trident and a pizza?
No, the guy that started Little Caesar's Pizza owns the Red Wings and the Detroit Tigers.
What? Pizza had the Detroit...
Yep,
Detroit
Pizza Pizza. And those commercials are what made him so famous, too.
From two words that are... It's like my new commercial says, love. Cause like, it's like pizza. Garlic knots, knots.
He was Greek. He was Mike Ilitch. He was Greek, so that's why they had the pizza, like a little Greek guy.
You know too much
about
this.
Which had nothing
to
do with pizza.
That dude was Greek. His name was this. Are you doxing?
He was
pizza,
Greek.
Pizza?
I swear to God, he's Greek. He's passed away. Rest in peace, but he was Greek.
Rest in Greece. Fucked up. I can't believe
he wasn't even Italian, but he know how to make a pizza quick. They started with like these like banquet halls around here, and that's where like everybody went for like their like baseball and soccer like banquets. You went to a Little Caesars like banquet hall, it was called back then. And the big thing was that they had this like phenomenal salad bar. That's like his claim to fame, that he had a nice salad bar. And then he figured out how to make $5 pizza. No, I'm serious. That's it.
I know.
Is that like not? That's like the most like American thing ever.
I made a salad bar. And I put my pizza in there. I put my $2 pizza in my salad.
Is it not the most American thing ever, though?
But what comes next? I put fidget spinners next to the soda machine.
You know what? He has all sorts of trinkets and that because the kids own it now. That we're all his kids, and they've got like.
Do you know who I'm jealous of?
They got everything to upsell you. It's like, hey, do you want some of this? Do you want some of this with your $5 pizza? How about some of this?
Do you want to know who I'm jealous of?
Who's that?
The people that make straws for tapioca drinks. Bubble tea.
Those big son of a bitches.
Because there's only like one company probably making bubble tea straws. It's probably like,
you know what?
There's probably a shitload of people like, making bubble tea. Like I got tapioca.
There's only like three or four of those in the Detroit area, and it's where like a lot of Asian people are.
Well, yeah, I'm trying to break down the whole entire process of bubble tea. It's sugar.
No, but I
it's sugar,
know it's,
water.
It's more popular. Like New York, it's like a fad.
Everything is a... Well, okay. Yeah, I am in New York, so I have a fucked up point of view of it because everything's a fad to me. Because it is.
No, but I mean, it but it's that everywhere, sells though. When you got that many people there. You've got, like, I think, like, five times the people of the inner city of Detroit.
Do you know who figured out bubble tea before bubble tea figured out? Nesty. Or, did you ever make iced tea? Iced tea? You got the fucking cardboard container filled with sugar?
Oh yeah,
that's
or sun tea. My mom used to make it with like she set like this big jar on the
that's bubble tea. But now bubble tea they had to change it to put tapioca in to sell the straws.
It's got those little lumps in it.
It's
goo. Is it goo? I don't know. It's like good goo.
And do you chew them or do you swallow them? That's always the question. Depends on how.
I guess that depends on the little lady that's drinking it at that time.
It's sugar, though. It's all just sugar. A Thai iced tea. Did you ever have a Thai iced tea?
Thai? No.
Thai iced tea.
What is that?
It's it's thicker than a bubble tea, and it's tastier. If you ever get Thai iced tea, I would say go for it if you don't mind your sugar intake for that week.
You're enlightening me to the teas that are...
Oh, I can tell you more about tea. I'm a big tea fan. I'm a tea.
I like... The tea I like is Dijerling, I think it's called.
Dijerling? Yeah, you know what's fucked up? I've been drinking PT Tips.
I hope that whistle came through correctly.
Oh my God, have you listened to that whistle? Beep, beep.
What is that?
This red button?
The T that you said.
It's a red circle with a phone on it. Have you ever seen that before?
What is it?
Have you ever talked to somebody that doesn't know about technology?
Yeah.
(917) 719-5923. I don't know what time it is. It's late. This is going to be a long show.
Nick, you take care, man. I just got word there's an escaped robot running around making lame comments. Just be careful. Shoot to kill. Shoot to kill.
Shoot. Help on the 917-719-5923. We might have some gas blasts. Yes, we do. Oh, fucker. Sultan Asoy, are you still playing Apex? Loba is thick. Thick.
Yeah, Lopez. And yeah, I do play it. And also, I still haven't bought any new hero ever. So I don't even have the first new hero, which was the electric girl or some shit. Or the heroine in the leg dude. As she's, girls, what's her name? She's great. Smoke. You can dodge some bullets when she's running. Apex Amazing Rella. That's what I call her. 917-709-5923.
Hey, Nick. It's Mike, the dick doctor. I'm really going to have to ask you and Zindu to stop competing. Sending me all those damn nudes and lewd graphic pictures. Look, I've seen your dick. I fixed it. I mean, I'm glad you're proud of it. It's much larger. But stop jamming your tail in there and taking pictures of it. Ugh. And Zindu, yeah, well, his five dicks and... he's got matching slits, and, well, I'm not going to go into that. I'm sure he's shown you the same pictures. But, yeah, please stop, or I'm going to have to disable my DMs. Thanks, buddy. I'm glad you're proud of my handiwork.
Hello? It's 2 in the morning, Eastern Standard Time. 2:10. Let's party on. Party on. With, Laid Back Luke. Chris Luke. Sundown. Wait. What? Really?
We are coming up. Oh, this is Zindu, by the way. I want to make sure everybody knows that the only captain on the SS sewer sub is me, Zindu, still. Even though the government told me to stop being captain. You know what I say to the government? I just spilled fucking rum and gin all over the fucking place. It doesn't matter. That's what I say to the government. Okay, we're coming up to something special. It's not a monster, but if you look out the left... down, you're gonna see a gunship from the Revolutionary War. This is one of the oldest things under this lake, other than Nick's unwashed underwear. Its name is the Spitfire. It was discovered in 1997, and it turns out to be one of Benedict Arnold's 1776 gondolas. 1776. This is a piece of history. This right here is a piece of history. Wait, we're getting a little bit too close to it. The heading students, I'm gonna hold that right. We're coming in a little hot. We're coming a little hot. Nick's might want to strap in. You might want to get your seatbelt on. The area is protected by sunken military craft out. Monsters. We were never in this area. Let me just try to scrub these radar records and, oh, fuck, how do you get rid of the logs? I gotta log into this thing, and I gotta log in to get the logs clean. I feel like we're getting really close. If you look out of the windows, any window, anywhere, you're gonna see a lot of debris right now in the water. It's probably because a lake monster... Oh, yes, it... Yes, this is a great sign. A lake monster must have ran into a priceless relic of America's history or something in this area. It seems like there's... Oh, fuck. We gotta get the fuck out of here. Captain, out.
Yeah, I was just going to warn you about that Antifa out there causing all the violence and... leaving bricks everywhere, and you know, it created quite a calamity out there. You see them, They usually got a helmet on and goggles and carry a skateboard, but it's not a cool skateboard. It's like them half a fag skateboards from back in the day from the Walmarts and the other big box stores around town. But you'll see these effeminate men walking down the street, and they cover their face because they don't want to get beat up because they're usually weak. They're referred to commonly as soy boys or cuck boys. Generally, people, they're the kind of people you just want to punch in the face. So they don't stand for anything other than ripping us apart, and they want to rebuild. But they have no plan to rebuild, Crancia. They're just winging it. So just going to warn you. So you see any of them? Hell, they had the one here got busted. Then his mom and dad took him out of the basement, took him down, turned him into the cops for starting a cop car on fire. So that's the level of wussy weaselness we're dealing with here. So just keep that in mind.
Agreed. Don't be a weasel. No weaseling, people. Only do what, alright, look. You could do stuff that could benefit you. And it might work out incredible. So just do it? Fuck. Okay. It's 2:15. We got more voicemail. Oh yeah, we do. Oh, sugar loaves. Here comes more voicemail.
So I just wanted to tell you that my underwear is free of stains. Any stain that you could imagine, it's not on my underwear. Free of stains. Stain-free underwear. Now, I've tried to stain it through various means, but I think it's space age, space force technology that my underwear remains stain-free. It's crazy. I've tried pooping in it. I shitted. I farted. I cummed all in it. Still no stains. So if you want to try and stain my underwear for me, just let me know and I will gladly let you. Thanks.
You're welcome. We have more show to go. Not over yet. I think I have to move things around though. A little bit. Not too much. Oh, we have to play an advertisement now? Oh, fuck. Okay. Let's play some advertisements. We'll be right back with more Nick the Rat Radio. I'm sorry how long this episode is. It's not my fault. It's the advertisers. They told me to pull it as far as I can. Do you know how many words I had to repeat, like so and if, just to make this fucking show this long? Give me a call at 917-719-5923. How deep are we? Oh,
Scrub brush, only in the darkest of sewers.
Hi, are you suffering from pain, physically or mentally? Are you trying to mask the pain with medication? Are you now currently addicted to this medication? We heard your cries. We saw a market and bottled it. Our dark sewer scientists have perfected the anti-addiction pill. Now you and your loved ones can finally free yourself from incessantly taking over-the-counter prescribed medication and switch over to something more natural. Right out of Mother Nature's man-made anus, the sewer. While supplies last, you can get a bottle with 420 pills for $69.99. Stop using Band-Aids when you can use nukes. And start taking Dark Sewer Anti-Addiction Pills today. Order now. 917-719-5923. Scientist standing by to take your calls 24/7.
Billy, for the last time, you have to eat your lunch. Now put it all in your mouth, chew it, and swallow, just like I told your dad to do last night.
But, Ma, I'm sick of your peanut butter and jelly sandwiches. I think I have malnutrition, and the kids at school are making fun of me because I'm malnutrition!
Oh, I've heard this story before. A lot of people have problems feeding their kids properly. So why don't you pick up the new bottle of Dark Sewer mayonnaise? That's right, we've got all 52 flavors of mayo that you crave. Your kids crave it too. We can tell because they told us so. So next time your kid's starting to bitch about their plain old peanut butter and jelly sandwiches, slap a slather of Dark Sewer mayo on top of that and watch his face light up as drips down his chin with white gooiness, just like your husband last night. Order now for only $69.99 from Dark Sewer Network. Tell them that Brody sent you. Ha ha.
Oh, that beep. Oh, yeah. So I was just calling to ask, you know, Zindu, do you really play that piano? Oh, wow. With all 5 of your dicks? Oh, God, I can only imagine. I can only imagine all that pounding on the keys and how fucking dirty and nasty your spit and that pre-cum and the splatter of your dick would cause all over that. Oh, oh, wow. I can only imagine the print. The keypad, the damn, the what do you call the damn, prints, the key, the music prints. Oh my God. Can you imagine how valuable those would be with Zindu's cum all over them?
This is Clara, calling to confirm an appointment for Albert's dong massage for Nick the Rat. Your dong massage is scheduled for 4:30. Thank you.
Hey, Nick R! Holy shit! I was just about to tune into your damn show, and I'm getting my dick sucked, and I was like, I pushed the wrong damn button. I called your ass.
So while I'm getting my dick sucked by Zindu, I figure I'd give you a finish calling, you know, that damn ring. So I love you, buddy. I'll miss you in my butt.
Beer. Drink it. Sugar. Eat it. Car. Drive it. Drugs. Take them. Shop. Buy it. Nick the Rat Radio. Donate to it. This message was approved by the U.S. government.
I think that might be a lie. I don't know who these dark scientists are, but it doesn't work like that. Gas blast. Is it a clam or a phone? It can't be both. God damn it, it just can't. Easy to use the joke when it is fed to you. Being fed lines just works. Where are we? Underwater. Zindu, are you trying to kill us out here?
Hey, Nate, you see my asshole scratcher?
Oh, God.
Yeah, I really, really need it, and I'm kind of getting tired of using your toothbrush. All right, thanks, man.
Well, I think I gotta throw my toothbrush away. We're getting close to the end here, I think. I'm not seeing too much else going on in the gas blast. Hey, S still water. How many times he folds and rolls his pasta dough? Need to know. That caught me off guard. That was good. It was like on air Dr. Seuss. What was he smoking?
Nick, I love how enthusiastic your voicemail always is. It makes me want to call you every day.
Oh, okay, well then, don't. It's not that enthusiastic, trust me. It's kind of, but not really.
Hello, this is Karen. I want to talk to the manager. Your name's Karen. K-A-R-E-N. Talk to the manager of this sewer. Swear. Sound like anything at all down here. Set two for one. I don't even know what that is, but I didn't get it. So I want to talk to the manager. I get to talk to the manager. I'm going to be ripping rat tails and kicking rat butt. You understand me, mister?
I think they would close 7-Eleven if there was... I would imagine... Actually, you know what? I bet you I could go to the corner store right now. I got a corner store. Oh, man. I think I don't mind living in a sewer in Brooklyn because there is a corner store that I could probably go to and get diapers and poops and I could shit and get beer and Coors. Coors is like the diapers of alcohol. And I could probably get one right now if I wanted to. I wish there was a weed factory right here, though. Oh, wait, looks like we have more voicemail. Let's see what we have. We're going to play that one right here. That looks like... Yeah, but...
It's probably better that you didn't pick up, even though you said that your phone lines are open.
What?
Oh, what? I have some crazy questions.
Oh, you can call in.
Okay. Okay. I can't do it. Well, all right, bye.
Oh.
Great show.
Sometimes, you probably called when I was on, there's like a million godzillion people calling, but it I'm still, you know.
Man, you're telling me to be relaxed, just, you know, really relaxed.
Yeah.
I did.
Yeah.
And half of my organs slid out.
Whoa.
Yeah.
Whoa. I don't want to be liable.
Okay, this is Karen.
Oh, no.
You just found out that you used me in your artwork.
Oh, no.
Where's my money, huh?
All right.
I'm not getting paid. Look, use my image.
That was...
I want to talk to management right now about your artwork.
It's...
Fancy little neck to rat.
It's fucking... It's parody.
Think you're so fancy.
It's fucking... It's collage. It's parody.
Come down there.
It's cheap. It's cheap. I'm not making money.
Ratify you.
There's no money
if
involved.
That's the thing. I want to talk to management. Karen, out.
There's no money. I do not sell that art. I give it away for free. Parody. It's parody on visual levels. God damn. Getting late. This is the longest episode of Nick the Rat ever. I went from not being here to being here too much. Let's listen to a musical interlude. My laid back Luke, we got Chris Lake. Sundown. Is this?
Yeah, motherfucker. I thought I told you one time, I'll tell you 16 times. Stop blasting that monkey bullshit up from the sewer. You're trampling my HS signal down in Mexico. I can't get my slave labor toast made. I can't get my signal down there because you're trampling my motherfucking signal. I can hear that shit coming up through my...
Get on the greener putt.
We're not using this ad-lib track. Maybe make the ad-libs louder than the verse. Are you gonna keep this whole in part? This is way too long. You should cut it off at some point.
Hi, everybody. I'm looking to see if there's any guest blasts left. I gotta end the show. Where are we even? We went in the water. I'm deep underwater. I've had a couple of nosebleeds. I'm feeling decent, though. Is there any more sewer chats? Gas blast over here? Maybe it's a double word. Gas. Space blast. Not gas blat. That's not the show. Okay, that's it. I think that's it. I think we're coming to an end here. Wait. The light's lighting up over here. I think that means Zindu.
Hey, Nick. Yeah, this is Captain Zindu coming to you from the cabin of the SS. Sub-sewer-sub-sub-sub-sub-sub-sub-sub-sub-sub-sub-sub-sub-sub-sub-sub-sub-sub-sub-sub-sub-sub-sub-sub-sub-sub-sub-sub-sub-sub-sub-sub-sub-sub-sub-sub-sub-sub-sub-sub-sub-sub-sub-sub-sub-sub-sub-sub-sub-sub-sub-sub-sub-sub-sub-sub-sub-sub-sub-sub-sub-sub-sub-sub-sub-sub-sub-sub-sub-sub-sub-sub-sub-sub-sub-sub-sub-sub-sub-sub-sub-sub-sub-sub-sub-sub-sub-sub-sub-sub-sub-sub-sub-sub-sub-sub-sub-sub-sub-sub-sub-sub-sub-sub-sub-sub-sub-sub-sub-sub-sub-sub-sub-sub-sub-sub-sub-sub-sub-sub-sub-sub-sub-sub-sub-sub-s literally have your lives in my hand. Don't worry, we're all gonna make through. We're gonna get through this, right? I feel like I'm talking like Joe Biden right now. Nick, you ever get the bends, by the way? Because we're gonna rise up really quickly. to see if I could kill you in the submarine and take the show off. You know, alright, we already surfaced and you already look like you're alive. Shit. Yeah, well, you might be questioning, why did we come to the surface? We were just down, like, 420 feet in the fucking lake, looking for a monster. There's no monsters on the surface other than humans. But anyway, I just wanted to show you something, okay? Now, there's some ancient rocks over here. We're in an area where there's ancient rocks. Actually, aren't all rocks ancient? Like, there's not, like, fucking new rocks. They're all fucking ancient. They're actually... Now that I think of it, that's pretty funny. Anyway, I think we're close to something. I think we're going to find something big here. This is definitely monster-infested waters over here. If you peer out of the window on either side, you're going to see some petroglyphs from American Indians. That's kind of fucked up that I'm saying that. From tribes of people. Indigenous people of the American... I don't know. Okay, don't send me letters. Don't send any letters to me. Send them to nick@nicktherat.com. Tell him that he's an asshole. Okay, so look on the left side. On the left side, right there. That's where the Mohawks lived, okay? Now I know that because somebody told me someday. Anyway, you can see in the rocks, they carved these pictures of this creature. Look at that. Look at that rock over there. You see that rock? And you see the carvings in there? Yeah, it's like a three-year-old could have done that. But, you know, in ancient times, a three-year-old was pretty advanced. That's how it works. Just does. You know, they didn't have fucking Crayola back then. They had sticks and stones. Anyway, they carved this picture of this long-necked beast. You see it? See, that's what we're looking for right now. We're looking for that long-necked beast right there. And this just proves that this gotta be real because the Mohawks did this shit. They called this the Onorakoa, okay? It means a great snake. I'm not talking about my dick, yes. One of my dicks is the great snake. The other one is the great serpent. And I also got the great hydra. And I also have a great fucking long sticky thing. I got like five of them. But anyway, one of them is the great serpent. The great snake. You know, kind of like the one in my pants. Anyway, on the right side, if you look at the right... Okay, look really far away because we're closer to the Mohawk side on the east. But on the west, the Abernaki. They also drew... A great fucking, like, sea serpent, long-necked beast motherfucker. So this proves that it's gotta be real, because the people on the east side of the river and the west side of the river both drew, like, the same thing, and they both had, like, name for this monster. They called this one the Abernaki. They called it the Pitiscog or something. Yeah, it means underwater horned serpent. Talking about horny snakes. I was out with this girl last week. Her name was Becky, and, Never have sex with a fan, Nick. Especially crazy ones. Never stick your dicks. Never. Need none of them. Not even if you have five of them. Don't stick two of them into crazy. It's a long story for another show. Anyway, well, see, these two ancient tribes of people that lived here, they both drew, like, a similar creature that they saw in these waters. That's proof. If that's not proof, you know, go fuck yourself. This water is also known to be filled with prehistoric fish like gars and sturgeons, and these Indians never lie. I never heard a story about lying Indians. So I think we're here. We're going to take the sub, we're going to take the SS sewer sub, and we're going to go down, dive deep right here, because this is the area. I think we're going to find some kind of crazy monster here. So hold on to your dick, Nick. We're going to go down and just let your viewers know that they're in for... They're in for some shit. Anyway, this is Captain Zindu. I'll come back in a little
People,
bit.
People, we're getting close. Sounds like we're getting close to monsters in the lake. Let's chill out. There's monsters in the lake, but that's fine. Because we have music to help. You know, when you have music, you could just go anywhere. You could go into a dark room, or you could open a letter from your insurance agency or bill provider. It's like, yo, we want this from you because you are this area of people, and if you can't be in this area of people, then you gotta go to the other area of people where you are. And that sucks. Because we get like that. Yeah, like, there you go. Hey, welcome to Earth. That's what you get right there. Wait. That's too much. You get like that. You get like... There you go. That's what you get. Maybe. It's very small. Very small amount. You get very nothing. It could be so much better. There's possibilities for incredible situations. But since we're using science and quantum computers to rule our lives, then I guess it's going to be whatever. Let's listen to a music over here. We got a music by Laid Back Luke, Chris Lake, Sundown. I think that is. We're getting close to the end of the show, everybody. Nessie, we're not in Scotland. We're in Lake Champlain. Did you know that there was a boat out here from Arnold Benedict that sank in 1776 called the Spitfire? It got wrecked by the monster in the lake. What would you call a monster in Lake Champlain? Champlain. It's French. How about Le Monster?
Déjà vu.
You're a badass motherfucker.
Building a rat ship.
Welcome back to Nick the Rat Radio. This is the longest episode in... You can check the Guinness Book of World Records in apparently 233 episodes. This one here was it was at least 6 or 7 inches long, I think. Is that how you measure the screen? 920 by 1080? That's the problem with digital. Digital has a... What is that called? Distortion of whatever you want, whenever you want it. It's a, it works though. So you could distort things how you want to distort it, and once you get it to where you want it to be, it's kind of mesmerizing. Okay. It looks like Zindu wants to talk a little bit more. Wait, do we have any more voicemail or anything? Jeez, we don't. That's it. It's just me and Zindu down here. I'm looking at... Oh, fuck. Okay, I'm looking at the notes. It's just me and Zindu. Zindu.
Nick, this is Zindu. Yes, you're captain. In the cabin. Captain is captain. Cabin. It's captain's cabin. And you're in the passenger cabin. Alright, shut the fuck up, though. Make any loud noises. I turned off all the lights. Don't make any noises. Don't make any sudden movements. And shut the fuck up. Now, if you look out of the sewer sub sunroof, you're gonna see it. There it fucking is. I fucking told you we'd find a map down here. I knew that map that I bought for $69 wasn't a ripoff. Oh, you see this? Now, this map fucking sucked too. This alien map. Don't go by maps. By instinct. Anyway, look. There it is. That motherfucker right there. Its name is Champy. You know, I know that because, wearing that dog collar that says Champy on it. Look at you, read it really closely. That's Champy. It's the Loch Ness Monster of the Northeast. Some say it's 20 feet long. But look, this motherfucker grew. Look at it. Look at it. It's fucking, it definitely grew. It's not 20 feet no more. It's like 20, 30. That's 33 feet at least. It's 30. Oh my god. Look at that thing. Samuel de Champlain wasn't lying. When he actually saw that fucker. That French guy wasn't fucking lying. He said he saw it, and there it is. I knew it. I knew I should have believed the French. Can't believe I even said that. That's crazy. I spotting a monster. Underwater. An ancient monster. Will make you appreciate the French. That's mind-blowing. There it is, though. Look at it. It looks like it has a horse's head, much like your mother. And it's probably... The mouth on it is probably as large as hers as well. Oh, my God. It's beautiful. Look at that thing. It appears to be a silvery gray. Kind of resembles a Pleasure Source Rex of ancient times. Oh my god. Oh my god, look, there's a family of them coming this way. Oh, look at them swim over us. Holy fuck, this is changing my life. You owe me big time for this shit, Nick. Oh my god. Once I get you back to the sewer, you're gonna write me a big fat check for this, motherfucker. Oh my god, look at that. Oh, they just passed over. What is it? Ew. They pass by, they're gone. That's all you get to see of them. They just swim on by, and it's not like they're gonna, like, fucking talk to us or anything. Yeah, I know, it's kind of upsetting. Anyway, well, they pass by. It looks like they left a long stream of shit and cum in our path. Might take us a while to get out of here. Anyway, well, I hope you and your listeners had a great time down here. Don't forget that you can send nudes to your P.O. Box. That's Nick at P.O. Box 90549, Brooklyn, New York, 11209. That's, make sure you send all your nudes to Zindu, to P.O. Box 90549. And make sure you sign it to Nick, not to Zindu, because, you know, Nick didn't let me get put it. I'm sure he'll give them to me. Brooklyn, New York, 11209. I hope you had a great ride in the SS sewer sub. Zindu was your captain. I hope you come back next week when we have more thrilling adventures, just not with me being a captain anymore, because the government told me to fuck off doing that shit. Those assholes. Government's everywhere. We gotta, like, shut them down somehow or get some type of change or reform, because they're really overstepping their bounds lately. They're really, really overstepping their bounds lately. Anyway, I hope you had a lovely ride with us. This is the SS Sewer Sub. Zindu out.
Did you guys see that thing? Did you hear it? That was a Champy? Champy. I thought I was Champy. This is weird. It's weird when you're faced with yourself sometimes. Sometimes you come into play into your own life, and it's weird. It's very strange, but hey, why not get involved in your own life? When you see the obstacle, you have a very good view of the obstacles in front of you. I gotta go. It's late. Let's listen to one more song, and we're gonna have a great evening. We're gonna have a great week. We'll be back more with more Make the Ride Radio. Make the Ride Radio. Drips. Zach here. Underwater. Have a good night, everybody. I hope you're there again next week. We can share times together. That's not the link. If you want the link, it's on my SoundCloud. That wasn't it. Oh, there it is. I got it. I'll post it now. You gotta make it as accessible as possible, but sometimes you want to get paid, and that's where the value for value mechanism comes into play. It's the people that could afford it, for whatever they see the value is. could support everybody for what's needed. It's a beautiful symmetry that works. But once you put up a wall, once that first wall comes up, it better be a good one. It better be a good wall. If it's not a good wall, it will get rejected and you'll get shut down. But hey, if it's a good wall, it's a good wall. Just work your way up. Work your way up. Try to support the bottom. And you'll rise like a gas bubble, like a fart, a burp. It'll be a burp. You might be a fart in start. You might fart at start. It'll happen. But one day you'll become the burp. You'll go from fart to burp. It happens to all of us. You might be a fart forever. A constant fart. It'll keep you at the top. I cannot believe I saw a dinosaur tonight.
These are great.
May I turn this on?
Fire one.
So what happened, in your opinion?
What are you talking about?
Well, don't you think the public perception of your work has significantly altered in the last 5 years?
That's your first question? I thought this was supposed to be a puff piece.
Should we come back to it?
Yeah.
Okay. Is it true that this is going to be your last voyage?
Wow. No comment. Who told you that? No, goddammit. I'm only 52. I'm always start out with some stock dialogue. You know, favorite color, blue, favorite food, sardines.
How do you feel about part one of your new film?
Why, how do you feel about part one of my new film?
Well, I'm honest, you know, so...
Just say it.
I thought aspects of it seemed slightly fake.
Wolodarsky?
Take five, Steve.
I like taking five. Did it seem fake when my best friend was bitten in half right in front of me? Then eaten alive, screaming? I think you're a fake. I think you're a phony and a bad reporter. How does that feel? Now tell me something. Does this seem fake?
How dare you?
Don't kill animals!